The 2011 Stanley Cup playoffs have been nothing short of electric. And through two games between the Detroit Red Wings and San Jose Sharks, we have come to expect the unexpected. Moves to the Motor City, where the next hero is laying in wait for one of these two NHL powerhouses. San Jose with a chance to take a stranglehold on the series. Detroit looking to strike back with vengeance. Sharks, Red Wings, Game 3, right now. It's Game 3 of the Western Conference Semifinal between the Sharks and the Detroit Red Wings. The San Jose Sharks as a group are confident, and for good reason. They captured the first two games of this best-of-seven on home ice, and now they take their show on the road, where they are a perfect 3-0 this playoff season. Hi again, everybody. Randy Hunt with Drew Remenda and Brody Brazil. Welcome live to Detroit. It is Game 3 as this series moves to Michigan. Drew, the Sharks won two excellent tight hockey games at HP Pavilion in San Jose, and some unlikely characters came up huge.
If you're going to go for a long run in the playoffs, you're going to have scoring from as many places that you can get it. Unexpected scoring. And we look at the San Jose Sharks. Ben Ferriero in overtime in Game 1. Ben Ferriero, you didn't think he was going to be the guy who was going to be the hero. You move into a situation in Game 2. Ian White, who has been masterful in this playoff series, he gets a big goal on the power play. And Nick Vallin, yeah, Nick Vallin rips one past Jimmy Howard. Now, the unexpected scoring is a great thing, but the San Jose Sharks aren't getting scoring from their big guys. Todd McClellan, though, says he likes their game. He likes how they've had offensive zone pressure. He just wants them to get rewarded, but he thinks their puck recovery and those second and third chances, that reward will come.
All right, so you have a group of Sharks who are coming through a little bit unexpectedly, and then you have some high-end offensive talent ready to turn on the red light. One of those players is Devin Setoguchi with Brody Brazil.
Devin, so far in this series, a lot of atypical goal scorers for the San Jose Sharks. How much are guys like you with a reputation for lighting the lamp just itching to get on the board?
Definitely I want to contribute and put a couple goals in the back of the net, but when you got such a deep offensive team like ourselves, it obviously feels good and takes a lot of pressure off the guys that do score a lot when we put those in. And, to get goals from our defensemen, it definitely helps. And, it makes it easier for us to win games.
Players say it's tough to win here in Detroit. What is it about Joe Louis Arena? Is it any different than the other 29 NHL rinks?
Maybe a little bit, but it's still the same. On the road, it's hard to win because teams are so excited to play in their own building. So for us, we just got to make sure that we stay focused, we're prepared, and we come out and have a good start and make it through the first 10 minutes and play the game that we can control, and we'll be all right.
Maybe some juggling in the top two lines. One thing that won't change, Joe Thornton will center your line. How much is he just a pillar, though, to all the forwards in general?
He's the captain that drives the ship. That's the way it goes. He's got to be our best forward up front, and we follow him. So it's obviously a bonus to be out there with him and get the opportunities on the offensive side, in their zone. So it's good. And we need to make sure he's going every night, and that makes everyone like us going as well.
Devin, have fun out there.
All right, thanks.
Randy and Drew.
Drew, there's so much star power in this series near the top of that list. Two of the big stars in the league, Joe Thornton and Pavel Datsyuk. Start with Joe. He's been a great two-way player all year, but he's taken it to another level in this playoff series.
He certainly has. A lot has been made about Joe's play away from the puck, or what Joe has changed. Well, what we see with Joe Thornton is that his game has evolved. His game is continuing to mature. He is much more detailed in every aspect of the game, from scoring goals to being defensively good prowess, to working hard on the faceoff, to battling and battling and battling until he gets the job done. Joe Thornton has certainly been a change in his game, but the change in his game is that he's a harder player to play against.
Pavel Datsyuk has assists in both the games in the series. He's always a treat to watch.
Mike Babcock called him the best forward in the series so far. Certainly for the Detroit Red Wings, that is the case. He's a master at taking the puck away. He's tough on the faceoffs, but he's also brilliant in his passing. Pavel Datsyuk, you've got to keep an eye on him tonight. Always know when he's on the ice.
All right, let's talk goaltending in this series, obviously. Key, especially when you have such a low-scoring series. Only 6 goals scored so far in the 2 games. Jimmy Howard's 0 for 2, but he's been a hard luck loser.
He's been spectacular. Jimmy Howard, very confident goaltender. Moves very well, very athletic. Gets outside the crease. You see how much confidence he has. He runs the battle and get out and take away the angle. Antti Niemi, his compact economy movement has been outstanding in this series, and he's made second and third saves at times that are critical moments. With Antti Niemi, he stopped those really tough big close opportunities. Antti Niemi starting to get back to where he was earlier in the year.
Great contrast between Niemi's first round against the Los Angeles Kings, where the Sharks were taken to 6 games, and in fact, Niemi didn't last the whole 60 minutes in a couple of those contests. A much better performance, obviously. The goals against average under 1.00 so far for Antti Niemi. A look at the ice here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. A packed house here for what is arguably the biggest game of the year for the Detroit Red Wings, Drew. They pretty much have to win game 3.
That's exactly what Mike Babcock said. Mike Babcock said that if they're going to, they have to win on one hockey game, and it's got to be this hockey game. You go down 3-0 against a team playing as well as San Jose, there's going to be some problems for the Red Wings. This is a huge, huge night.
Last year, the Sharks came into this building in the same scenario, up 2-0, and it required overtime, but they took a 3-0 lead in the series and, of course, went on to win it in a 5th game. The Red Wings are very cognizant of that. Their roster is full of players who went through that experience, and the last thing they want is to go down 3-0 and fight the odds, which say that most teams never come back. Now, let's go to ice level here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit for the national anthem.
All fans, may we suggest you remove your hat. Active military personnel, retired military personnel, may keep their hats on while rendering the military salute. Singing the U.S. national anthem, the Red Wings' own, Karen Newman.
And bright stars through the perilous fight. O'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the Rockies' red glare, the bombs bursting in air.
moment here in Detroit with the national anthem. And now let's look at our McDonald's starting netminders for game three. Antti Niemi, the first star of game two. He had 33 saves. He is unbeaten in this building, but it's his first playoff game, 4-0 career in the regular season. Jimmy Howard, well, he's been pretty good for the Detroit Red Wings, too. He stopped 79 of 83 San Jose shots. He's allowed only 4 goals in 2 games. Unfortunately, that's all it took for the Sharks to win, at least from Howard's standpoint, unfortunately. Fortunately for Todd McClellan's Sharks, they played arguably their best playoff game in a long time in game two. Mike Babcock Drew is expecting his team to bounce back with their best playoff game of this year.
Yeah, he's putting a lot of onus on the first 10 minutes of this hockey game. He wants to get his hometown fans here, and he wants his team to be in it right away. The first 5-10 minutes of this game might decide it.
Joe Pavelski stands at center ice, flanked by his usual line mates Kyle Wellwood and Torrey Mitchell. Some changes for Detroit, though, as Pavel Datsyuk and Henrik Zetterberg are not starting on the same line tonight, and we'll get to that when we look at the lines and defense pairs in just a few moments. But the Red Wings pulling out all the stops here to try and get a game back in the series, and a puck out of play off the opening faceoff. Let's go to those lines for the Sharks. And Todd McClellan is staying pat, Drew, except on the fourth line.
Yeah, when you look at what Todd McClellan's looking at, why would you change? You mentioned the fact that the San Jose Sharks have played an outstanding playoff game in game two. They put a little bit more energy, a little bit of change of things with Jamal Maris coming in. What that does is it continues to bring some energy, some physical play as well. And the defense stays the same. They have been brilliant so far in two games.
So Ben Eager, who played in game two, not in the lineup here for game three tonight here in Detroit. And we'll look at those Red Wing lines as well in just a couple of moments as the puck is steered into the Detroit zone. Back is Brad Stewart defensively for the Red Wings. And Douglas Murray able to get it right back into the Red Wing zone as Nicholas Lidstrom now takes the handoff from his netminder. And this crowd is jacked up here in Detroit. They realize what's at stake for the Red Wings. The odds of coming back 3 games to nothing down are slim. It was done last year, but it doesn't happen very often. In fact, teams that go down 3-0 in a playoff series have a 1.8% chance in the history of the NHL to win the series. So it is a slim opportunity, to say the least.
We saw it last year with Philadelphia Flyers and Boston Bruins, but pretty tough.
Johan Franzen trying to get pucks through to the net. That's a key for the Red Wings, but that one didn't reach. And now it's cleared by the Sharks. Marc-Edouard Vlasic to the board, supported on the same side by Logan Couture, but Jonathan Erickson picks it right back up in the neutral zone as he ran in to Danny Heatley. Here's Datsyuk now over the San Jose line, but the Red Wings are offside, and that's our cue to look at the Red Wing line combinations, and they have changes. Datsyuk and Zetterberg split up, and Chris Draper, the veteran, is back in the lineup for Detroit.
So what they want to do is bring more pressure down the middle, more speed down the middle, and with Chris Draper, he's an outstanding penalty killer as well. Now, Helm's going to play the middle there, but Draper can also come in and take faceoffs. Mike Babcock, actually an enjoyable rare moment this morning, gave the lines to the press, and then he said, and if we change up Zetterberg and Datsyuk, this is what Todd McClellan's going to do, and he gave the matchups to us. It was brilliant.
But in fact, at least to start, Todd McClellan has not done what Babcock suggested, and that was to take Patrick Marleau off Thornton's line and play him on the second line, swapping him out with Logan Couture.
If he does that, Todd McClellan would just say because he wants to bring a little bit bigger body down the middle of the ice if he thinks that Zetterberg needs to be matched up against Patrick Marleau.
Just an abdicator to Valtteri Filppula. Filppula down the wing. Now he'll look to feed it to the front of the net. Did. Broken up by the Sharks as Wellwood turns back toward his own goal.
Both coaches have talked about Randy this morning, and the first 2 games is not really about matchup. Mike Babcock says because the Sharks have been better.
Ballin with a slap shot caught by Jimmy Howard, unlike in game two, when Ballin's shot from a similar part of the ice went off Howard's glove and in.
He comes up the backside. Nick Ballin, same thing. He's going to come up the weak side, gets the pass, and then fires it on net. Sharks want to continue to pepper the puck at Jimmy Howard as much as possible.
What a series so far for Ballin. In the first 2 games, number 7 has 6 shots, 5 blocks, 4 takeaways, and a game-winning goal. Not bad work for number 7, Nicholas Ballin, who now has, in his career, 4 playoff goals, and they're all game winners. 3 with Carolina, and then the goal in game 2 for the Sharks. Patrick Eves sending it in, and the speedy Darren Helm first on it for Detroit against Demers. It's Eves now working against Scott Nichol. Eves sending it behind the net. Draper there, so is Nichol, so is Vlasic, and the puck comes out. Sharks will clear as Jamal Mayer sends it down the ice, and there will be a race to it, but it'll be touched for icing by the Red Wings. Well, let's take you back to game two, HP Pavilion, Sunday afternoon. And there is the goal by Nicholas Wallin.
Nick Pauline has got a heavy shot, and that surprised Jimmy Howard. Kelly Rudy, the former goaltender, used to talk about heavy shots and shots that go on you quick, or quick shots. He said heavy shots hit you and you can't believe it's coming that hard, and you try to get a hold of it, and you have to fight it off sometimes. Howard tried to fight that one off, but it was too much for him.
Pauline got his size into that shot. He's 6'3", 220. There's a shot from up near the blue line by Erickson, and Antti Niemi with his first save of note, and he saw that one come all the way through.
Clean faceoff win. There's Jamal Maris going to be in the lineup for the Sharks tonight, and what he's expected to bring is a physical presence, make sure he gets pucks out, and stay disciplined.
He's got a good game-winning to playoff goal ratio. Two of his five have been GWGs, as we say in the
biz,
play-by-play biz.
I've never heard you say that, ever.
You have now. As it's cleared back to center, Zetterberg on this line with Cleary and Bertuzzi. Marlowe takes the big hit from Dan Cleary, and they talk, the Red Wings did, about needing a big game from number 11 Dan Cleary. He leads them in the energy department, and he's also become a critical goal scorer for them as well. He had the series winning goal and a couple of assists against Phoenix. Here's a pass for Cleary, but too far off the end of his stick. Marlowe takes a hit to try and move it out of the zone, can't, and now Bertuzzi trying to work it back to Cleary. Demers, a nice job on the boards, and now Marlowe sends it ahead, gets it back from Thornton, and deep into the Red Wing zone it goes. We played 3.5 minutes here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit, and the San Jose Sharks with a 2-0 lead in this series, hoping to keep their winning streak in the playoffs going. They've won 3 in a row. Of course, game 6 against LA, and then the first 2 to start this series. Ruslan Saleh, he was strong for them in the opening round against Phoenix when they swept. Bronson's shot deflecting away back to Saleh. He'll play it to the net, and Niemi got a piece of that, but it was dangerous. And it's cleared out as Klo got rocked by Datsyuk. And Pavel Datsyuk with a physical play along the boards as we have a stoppage here.
We have seen a physical start from the Detroit Red Wings. They do some good work behind the net. This is where they think they can make some things happen. The defense are going to start to jump in and really activate, and they just throw the puck towards the net. So from the San Jose Sharks point of view, collapse back to the net. Make sure you pick up, if you're the wingers, pick up the points that are coming in.
Datsyuk has assists in each of the two games so far on the only two goals that Detroit has scored in this series. Torrey Mitchell working behind the wings net now. Fights off Rafalski. Then it comes through. Wellwood on the rebound behind the Detroit net, but he can't make the play as Hudler clears it back across the ice. Now Yuri Hudler entering the San Jose zone against Vlasic. And the save by Niemi. Big rebound. It's grabbed by Pavelski. Couldn't clear it. And now a hard shot from the point rims all the way back out. So Antti Niemi's already been tested a couple of times here in the early going. Two shots on goal for Detroit. Two quality opportunities. Vlasic. And Senaguchi's pass, not a good one. And an offside play against the Red Wings.
Close. Close call. The Sharks have been able to get the puck out of the zone with good frequency. Tom McClellan looking at his team now. One thing he's probably going to be pushing his team is, okay, we're going to withstand the storm, but you've got to make sure you push back. Right now, most of the play has been in the San Jose Sharks zone. And now you see Tom McClellan always with the reminders, always with the coaching, always with the teaching when players come back to the bench.
McClellan, of course, the former assistant coach under Mike Babcock here in Detroit. And it was for that reason, among many others, that the Sharks went after Todd McClellan. Obviously, the Red Wings have been a model franchise in this league for the past decade.
And, well, if you want to beat them, sometimes you have to imitate a little bit of what they do. And certainly bringing McClellan to the Sharks has done that, as these two teams are very similar in their style of play, if not exactly in the talent department. Different players bring different parts to the equation for both these teams, but they do play the same way.
Yeah, both coaches were talking about that very fact this morning, that both teams are evenly matched, and really sometimes it just comes down to the fact that you're going to beat the guy across from you in any given night.
Dan Boyle turns it over to Zetterberg. Now Cleary shot, and Niemi with the save.
Good forechecking by the wings for that chance.
Zetterberg all the way up to the point, cutting through the middle is Franzen. His shot deflected off Murray, and now off the screen on a touch. And the Red Wings buzzing here the last couple of shifts.
Red Wings seal off the boards, do a nice job. And they're going to go to the slot. Great save by Antti Niemi. Quick reaction. Niemi's well out of the crease to make that save. Todd Bertuzzi pressuring Dan Boyle. And then the nice seal on the boards. Both teams will always talk about sealing the boards on the forecheck. That is, you take the board option away from the puck carrier.
We mentioned he has never lost here on Antti Niemi. He's played four times in the regular season, twice for the Sharks, twice for the Blackhawks last year. 4-0, a 1.96 goals against, 941 save percentage, and a shutout.
How many goalies can say that in the National Hockey League?
Never lost at the Joe? Not many. Here's Stanley now as Detroit comes back up the ice. They've had the bulk of chances out shooting the Sharks right now, 3-2, but much more of the zone time. Heatley to center, gets the line, hands it off to Klo, and he's checked hard by Datsyuk. Puck behind the net, and Heatley giving it right back to Stanley, but the Red Wings able to come ahead with it. And Datsyuk will just dump it in from center ice. Vlasic. And Datsyuk's right on him, and Pavel Datsyuk came with the intent to be physical tonight. A tip in front, and it's cleared from the front of the net. We have a penalty coming up to the Sharks, and it's going to be interference. The Red Wings with a power play when we come back. It's time to check our Lexus keys to the game.
Well, for the San Jose Sharks, you got to keep your nose to the grindstone. You got to keep working on the puck. You got to keep winning the battles and winning those races to the puck. Own the offensive zone. Both coaches talked about that today. Second, third chances. Puck recovery. Keep pushing the team and wearing the other team out. For the San Jose Sharks also, they want the one and done for the Detroit Red Wings. Mike Babcock talked about it this morning. Got to make sure it's one and out of the zone.
He also talked about how the Sharks have been one and grind. They've outworked the Red Wings in Babcock's estimation. And I think if you've watched all six-plus periods of this series, you'd have to agree the Sharks have been the harder-working team. But despite that, it's just been by a slim enough margin that it has been such a tight and close series so far.
Mike Babcock keeps saying they've been better than us. They've been better than us. He talked about that one and done, that they haven't been able to recover pucks and keep the offensive pressure on.
Ryan Klo in the penalty box for interference. First power play of game three. Datsyuk sets up at the point. Now Brian Rafalski, who did not practice the last 2 days. He's nursing a sore knee, but he's out there at game time. Here's Rafalski back to Datsyuk. The reverse. Rafalski doesn't like the angle to shoot. Hands it off to Lidstrom. Gets it back. The one-timer. Saved by Niemi. And the big rebound off the active boards here in Detroit. But it works out for the Sharks as Pavelski clears.
Very attentive play by Mark-Edward Vlasic. And you called it right, partner, is the fact that the puck really jumps off the end boards here at the Joe. And the Detroit Red Wings use it to their advantage.
Sharks penalty kill in the playoffs. Improving as they go along. A nice save there by Howard on the shorthanded bid. Now the Red Wings come ahead 3-on-2. Hudler to Franzen, and the save by Niemi as he's come up big here in the early part of this game. Franzen back to the corner. Hudler for Cronwall. Off the net, the pass, and the glove save by Niemi. What a great display of goaltending early on here by Antti Niemi.
Wow. This could be the save of the game right off the bat here in the first period. Great play across the net. Antti Niemi comes across in the full splits, glove up, and snaps that puck out of the air. What a beautiful save by Antti Niemi. Terrific flexibility and athleticism. But a nice play by the Detroit Red Wings. Go across the ice because the Sharks are taking away that shooting angle. But Antti-Niemi, wow, that's all you can say is that's a beautiful save.
Detroit's power play just 1-for-8 in the first two games against the Sharks. But it's 22% in this playoff season, as they were very successful in the first round against the Phoenix Coyotes. And, of course, we know why. Just look at the people on the ice. We've got a whistle right off the faceoff.
I think it's just something about the faceoff that the referee didn't like. So the faceoff is now going to go. I think he's just kicking somebody out. I'm not sure what he didn't like about that.
No penalty on the play, so they'll do it over again from the very same spot. Joe Thornton will stand in against Johan Franzen. 38 seconds. Check at 39 to go and close penalty. And Thornton with the faceoff win. Wallin with the clear almost. And now Thornton does get it out. Heatley at center all alone. He'll just softly chip to the corner. Heading up the ice is Hudler. He'll take the pass. Dump it in from center. Wallin reacting. First to it. Overskated. Now White trying to clear it. That hit Thornton. Came right back to Ian White. Wallin legging it out up the boards. And he just does get it out past Cronwall. Danny Heatley again, all alone, but he gets a decent shot away, forcing Howard to make another shorthanded save as Klo comes out of the penalty box. So some good work by the Sharks later in the penalty kill, and before that, Antti-Niemi stealing the show. Mitchell now as the Sharks come in back to 5-on-5. His pass blocked by Saleh. Klo follows with a hard hit. Played back to Filppula. And now Ruslan Saleh turns back behind his own net. No score here in the first period of game three. Sharks with a 2-0 lead in the series. Thanks to identical 2-1 wins. Ben Ferriero with the overtime winner in game one. And then Nicholas Wallin with the regulation game winner in game two. Mayer's looking for the pass from Klo up through the middle. Back to Jimmy Howard. He rims it around past Erickson. Sharks have to clear the zone here, but Saleh has it anyway. And now it's back in through the neutral to Ferriero. To Couture. Logan Couture comes over the line. Jamal Mayer's a shot and a blocker saved by Howard. That one goes out of play.
Jimmy Howard not that busy, but the Sharks starting to now move the puck out of the zone. And get a couple of shots, although from outside. The Red Wings have moved the puck out of their zone very efficiently, very quickly. They've got great middle support. And San Jose has yet to put much pressure on Jimmy Howard.
Sharks have outshot the Red Wings in this series, 88-65. The biggest margin coming back in game one when the Sharks were all over the Red Wings, 46-25. And that's when Jimmy Howard probably set the tone for his level of play in this series when he made 44 saves in that game. Well, you make 44 and lose. That's heartbreaking.
That is tough. Tough to take. San Jose is the best teams in the league. They have outshot almost every one of their opponents this season.
If you're Mike Babcock and you're down 2-0 and Marleau hasn't scored, Thornton hasn't scored, Heatley hasn't scored, Couture hasn't scored,
you're worried.
You're worried. Because the big guns, you know they're going to get their points in a series for the most part. As Setoguchi hands it off to Joe Thornton. No losing the puck. Brad Stewart giving it back up. Marleau saved by Howard. Batted down by Setoguchi, but wide. And Thornton recovers it. Sharks top line here, creating some chances. This is Marleau. He'll try and wrist one through. Blocked by Lidstrom. Thornton back there for support, but Zetterberg cuts in front of him. And Henrik Zetterberg will now headman it quickly up the ice for Dan Cleary. Murray's got a bear down. As Cleary's angle shot was wide. Zetterberg back through to the net. And he got a piece of that. Marleau bumping it out of the zone just across the line. So the Sharks with that Thornton line getting a couple of good chances. But Zetterberg with a great breakout pass from his own zone got it going the other way. And Cleary with some chances for the Red Wings on the tail end of that chip. It stays 0-0 here. 9:20 left to go in period one. Datsyuk. Now Franzen, he'll lob one back through to Datsyuk, and Niemi, a smart play, got his stick down to deny that pass.
Yeah, Datsyuk will bring everybody over to one side of the ice, and then you forget about the most dangerous guy, which is the man going in on the backside.
Mitchell failed to get past center ice. Nice play by Rafalski. Now Wallin clears it back into Detroit territory. Erickson wants Thomas Holmstrom. He can't get a hold of that, and we'll have an icing call here against Detroit.
I'm going to show you what Detroit's trying to do. They've been doing this all game. As soon as the Detroit Red Wings look like they're turning out the puck, they're going to send a stretch man. So they're going to turn over the puck. There's the stretch man and Danny Cleary. He's taking off. They also send one high in the strong side, high in the weak side, the puck side. So what they'll do is they'll just bring the guy out of the zone, have him stand at the Sharks' blue line. That pushes the defenseman back and creates some open space.
Battle behind the net, and this is where so much of the Sharks' advantage has come in this series. Plays along the boards, whether it's behind the net, in the offensive zone, in the defensive zone. It seems when the puck is along the boards, the Sharks have an advantage with their size.
The L.A. series, I think, really helped. Look out!
Cronwall coming in and gets the big hit. And
he's still down.
Slow to get up is Danny Heatley. He did not see Cronwall making the cut. And Heatley shaken on the hit by the Red Wing defenseman.
A beautiful hit by Nick Cronwall. Comes in. Throws the body at Danny Heatley. Elbow down, shoulder down. Cronwall, who does this often and does it well, timed it perfectly on the breakout, puts Danny Heatley down. Danny has gone to the Sharks dressing room.
He was able to get up on his own power, took a twirl around the ice, had his skate checked over on the bench, but then did retire to the Sharks dressing room. We'll keep an eye on Heatley. From the faceoff, Ian White a blast. Howard drops the rebound. Ferriero with a backhand drive.
Henley coming up to the wings.
Got Nichols shaken up, but he gets back to his skates. He's got the puck now. As Niemi leaves the net, it's controlled by Detroit, and we get the whistle as Nichols lost his helmet in that exchange, but he's best off here to skate away and just take the punishment and the power play that the Sharks will now have.
Right from the faceoff, the San Jose Sharks get a chance. Win the draw, get it back. Ian White, who's been so good at moving laterally and getting shots towards the net. There's the rebound opportunity, and right in front of the net, there was the...
Darren Helm.
A high stick. Darren Helm actually gets a little bit tripped by Ben Ferriero, loses his balance and throws his stick back and catches Scott Nichol. Been a lot of accidental high sticks in this series so far, but Scott Nichol is fine. The Sharks get a power play after the big hit by Cronwall. A good response from the Sharks.
Well, the Red Wings might not have a win in this series, but I think they do have the hit of the series so far here in game three on that perfectly legal hit by Nicholas Cronwall that shook Danny Heatley. And now the Sharks are on the power play for the first time tonight. Pavelski on one point, Boyle on the other, broken up by Applicator, and now it's off the stick, and it will be off Applicator's stick and out, so the faceoff will stay in the Detroit zone. Sharks on the power play in this series are 2-for-11. They've scored a power play goal in each of the two games, and when you have one goal, two games that are both decided by one goal and low-scoring games, obviously the power play has been critical.
Yes, it has, and now the Detroit Red Wings are trying to pressure the points of the San Jose Sharks power play more than they have in the first two games.
Sharks on a Cache Creek power play here in the first period as we are looking for the first goal of game three. Datsyuk tossed out of the faceoff circle. Eves takes his spot against Jumbo Joe Thornton, who's been over 50% in each of the two games of this series so far. Joe, 50% in game two. Better than that, 59% in game one. Pavelski back up top to Boyle. Boyle's wrist shot, and that's blocked.
Hits Santaguchi in the leg.
Eves and Boyle knocked it down, spun around to find it. And now he gets it back. So no Danny Heatley on this power play, at least for now. There's Marlowe with a pass right into the feet of Cronwall, and that is cleared down. Minute 20 left to go here in this first power play of the game as Boyle leaves it for Thornton. Now on the rush, it's Marlowe. He cuts toward the net, looking to make a play, broken up nicely by Cronwall as Thornton sends it back high to Boyle. Setoguchi, Thornton couldn't pick it up, but Marlowe gets to the corner after it. Now in front, Setoguchi. He's got Pavelski, and he shot it over the net. Off the rebound, they score! Devin Setoguchi, a power play goal, and it's 1-0.
That's what happens when you get overly aggressive on the penalty kill. Two Detroit Red Wings go into the corner to place a hit on Patrick Marleau. That creates obviously an odd numbered situation where Pavelski tries to go high, big lively boards, and this time the San Jose Sharks take advantage of the jump off the end boards, but everybody goes to the front of the net. Good hands by Joe Thornton as he knocks that puck out of the air towards the net, and then Devin Santaguchi there to clean up in front. But what happened on that play was that Detroit was so aggressive that they got themselves out of position, and that created the first shot by Pavelski, which created the scramble.
Devin Santaguchi, who was the hero of game three in the second biggest comeback in Stanley Cup playoff history with his overtime goal, gets his second of the series and starts things out here on the power play. Now Rafalski is shot, and the Eddie had to fight through Holmstrom to see that puck, but he did. It's Thomas Holmstrom parked in front. Now Franzen, he's a load to handle out of the corner, but the Sharks so far have it contained as Cole puts a hit on the far side on Rafalski, and Ferriero clears it over the line, and now a break. Couture into the Detroit zone, and it's shot off Erickson's stick up into the screen behind Howard, and we'll have a faceoff in Detroit territory as now Erickson going after Ryan Clough as Ferriero is tied up as well away from the puck by Franzen.
Interesting thing, Brody Brazil talked to Devin Santaguchi, we talked about as the unusual scorers, the unexpected scoring from the San Jose Sharks in the first two games, and now Devin Santaguchi, one of the guys expected to put the puck in the net, one of the 720 goal scorers this year for the Sharks, gets on the board first.
So the big boys come through, Santaguchi from Thornton and Marleau, the top line combining for the first goal of the game on the power play, and the Sharks with the lead here in the first period, and now the faceoff in Red Wings territory. So for the great push that Detroit put on to start this game, their penalty kill, which has been one of their problems all year and continuing on into this playoffs, fails them there. They have given up 9 power play goals now, the Red Wings, in this playoff year. Scott Nickel, who drew that penalty that led to the Santaguchi goal, sends it in for Wellwood as Mitchell cuts in around Soleil, and then he's upended. Abdelkader tried to clear, gets it up the boards for Soleil.
Another stretch.
And it breaks down momentarily. Now Hudler shovels it back to Soleil, and he shot it high. Might have glanced off the glove of Niemi.
I think it did. It looked from our angle like Niemi got a piece of it.
Devin Santaguchi, a big goal here in the first period of game three.
Welcome back to Detroit. Sharks with a 1-0 lead, and here at Joe Louis Arena, where the Red Wings have certainly done their fair share of winnings, all you need to do is take one look up at the banners in the rafters. There's 19 division championships, 6 President's Trophies, 6 conference championships, and banners for 11 Stanley Cups. But then there's this, the things that the average fan does not see. These are the rosters of all the Stanley Cup winning teams. These are painted on the player hallways outside the dressing rooms. Now, besides just decorating the place, you'd have to think that seeing these names inspire the Red Wings every time they walk into the rink. And then, of course, a couple familiar nicknames there, or names, with Todd McClellan and Jay Woodcroft.
There is the Sharks head coach sizing up the situation. His team in front 1-0, as special teams, always so important in the playoffs, have come through for the Sharks in this series. 3 straight games now, Drew, with the power play clicking for the Sharks.
Also scoring a first period goal again.
Lidstrom, and that's deflected just wide through all kinds of traffic in front of Niemi.
Wasn't there. Everybody was going to the net.
Now Henrik Zetterberg, he'll flick one into that pileup. It hit Boyle, drops to Pavelski. And now Marleau will clear it out. We have not seen the return yet of Danny Heatley out of the Sharks dressing room after that hit from Nicholas Cronwall. Brody Brazil on that case as well. But of course, at this time of the year, there's not a whole lot of, let's say, useful information about injuries.
He's in or he's out.
It's in or out. We're not even at the lower body, upper body stage anymore. That's why it was so surprising to hear Brian Rafalski talk about his sore knee. You just don't usually hear players even referring to their ailments, even if everyone knows. Here's Zetterberg now for the Red Wings. They're down 1-0 here in this, well, not must-win game three, but it must seem like that to them. The odds stacked against 0-3 teams, and of course the Red Wings went through that last year against this very same Sharks team as they lost game three in an overtime on the big goal by Marleau. Here's Ferriero putting one to the net. Howard steering it aside to this side of the ice. Couture works it back Clough's way. Helm cuts in front of Ferriero and moves it to Soleil. 4.5 to go here in the opening period. The Sharks getting physical now, and they've got a 2-on-1 down low. Couture shoots it. Howard gobbles it up, and no rebound as Couture elected to shoot there with Ferriero going to the net, and that's a good play if there's a rebound.
He tried to get Jimmy Howard to open up. He faked, and Howard wasn't biting on anything. As Logan Couture comes in, he lifts the leg. He's going to fake now. He's looking for an opening now. He wants to get a quick shot away. You got Nick Lidstrom there. I like that play by Logan Couture just simply because you're going against Nick Lidstrom, who is the master of the stick, knocking pucks down, taking passing lanes away. Very quick stick defensively. So Logan, I think, made the right play, and Ben was looking for the rebound.
Ferriero back in the lineup, and of course, he was the surprise lineup change in game one of this series. Rewards his coach with a game winner in overtime. And here we are three games in now, and Ben Ferriero still in the lineup, and rightfully so. He's been productive and effective in that role. Vlasic, and coming in hard was Helm, but Vlasic took the hit, made the play, and the Sharks come through center. Pavelski, he'll lob it in. Look at the pinball effect off the boards, and the Sharks hit the post. Mitchell swung that through the crease. I believe it glanced the goalpost on the way through. Back the other way. A save by Niemi on the shot from the right side by Hudler. And now a penalty coming up down low in the Sharks' defensive zone. And it's going to go against Detroit, I believe.
Very clever play by Joe Pavelski. There's a smart hockey player. High IQ. Throws the puck off the end boards, which we see Detroit do all the time. Very lively. Big jump off the boards. And then Torrey Mitchell just misses. It is going to be to the Detroit Red Wings.
Chris Draper, his first game of the series, and he goes to the penalty box here at a rather inopportune time with his team down by a goal on the power play.
Big collision on the end boards. And there was Draper finishing the check. A high shot at, I do believe it was Jason Demers, that got hit.
16:07, time of the penalty to Draper. And now the Sharks right back on the power play where they just scored on Setoguchi's goal. And the faceoff won by Thornton. Boyle, the drop pass, Marlowe, his shot. Setoguchi looking for the tip as Pavelski tries to out-battle Abdelkader on the boards. Natsuk comes in and clears it just over the line. Draper got two for roughing. As Boyle drops it back for Pavelski, and now the Sharks on the entry. Well done, and then the shot saved by Howard was probably headed over the net, but he cleans it up nonetheless.
A good goaltender will want to control the game as much as he can and slow it down, especially if his team's shorthanded. So Jimmy Howard grabs it and makes sure he is able to get the faceoff that he wants. The entry into the zone has been something the San Jose Sharks have been working on all season long. That's a nice entry where you bring that space, use the space behind, and gain some speed on the people who are backing up in the offensive zone.
A shot saved by Howard. Rebound, Ryan Cole looking for it. Kept in at the line by Demers, but he stumbled, and then so did Helm. Otherwise, Helm might have been on his way in for a break.
He's got great speed, but Ian White, look out.
Helm again on a breakdown at the line. Any shot goes out of play.
Bobbling of the puck there causes the Sharks some problems. He's with the shot, goes high, but there's Danny Heatley coming back on the bench. Looks like he's fine. Cleaned out the cobwebs. He'll be ready to go again.
So Heatley, we'll see if he jumps in here on the power play, or Todd McClellan will wait till they get to 5-on-5. Cronwall with the big hit earlier in this period, trying to set the tone for Detroit, and they really did come out physically to start this game as we thought they would, try to take control of the atmosphere, the momentum, the crowd, and everything else. But then the goal by Setoguchi kind of quieted that effort, at least momentarily. Detroit obviously needs a big kill here. A minute 11 left to go.
Hit by Cronwall, face-off down in the zone. Chance by the Sharks, draws a penalty, Sharks score. That hit did not create the momentum that the Wings wanted.
Now Thornton, beautiful pass, shot, saved by Howard. The rebound jumps into the crease, and back out to Boyle. Ian White gives it back to Dan Boyle. Thornton just guides it Marlowe's way. He's knocked down by Stewart. Setoguchi will go up top again. Puck jumps over White's stick momentarily, but he'll give it back to Boyle. Marlowe down low. Thornton at the side. He had Setoguchi, but it was broken up. Ian White tees it up through to Thornton, and finding it is Howard. He didn't have it covered, but he got a benefit there of a little bit of a quick whistle.
the power play, creating scoring chances. Going to the net, Howard with the big splits makes the save, and the Sharks run into each other. Setoguchi and Thornton trying to get on the puck as they were going behind the net. Puck bounced out to the front. Jimmy Howard again showing that great athleticism.
23 to go on this power play. Puck recovered. Boyle waits, changes his angle, and then he lost the puck as he tried to toe drag around for that shot. Sharks are quickly trying to get back in here, and Couture will do that. Comes across the line, gives it to Heatley, so he gets back out there, Danny Heatley does, on this power play. Interference there as Stanley knocked Couture down, but he got away with it. Tail end of the power play. Sharks trying to get another chance here. Heatley spun around by Datsyuk, but he keeps the puck. Can't get it through to the net. Broken up by Datsyuk. Cole recovers it. We're back to 5-on-5 now. And Darren Helm will skate it out, and he's got Draper with him out of the penalty box. Helm is tripped by White. Penalty to the Sharks. Play continuing as Lipstrom gets it through, and it went off a skate. Kept alive by Datsyuk as Howard's out for the extra skater. Demers unable to get to that puck, but Couture will here, and we should have a whistle now. Well, no, they're not going to give control there. Now they'll have to as Heatley. No, they still don't. Shot saved by Niemi, and finally, the Sharks get a whistle for control. And a power play will begin for the Red Wings.
Gonna light on the sticks, the Sharks. Gotta be heavy on the sticks. Inadvertent tripping, but no doubt a tripping penalty as Ian White got his stick between the feet of Helm, and the Sharks on the penalty kill for the first time, no, second time this period. But you gotta be a little heavier on your sticks. In the playoffs, you gotta be heavy on the sticks. The Sharks have some big guys, strong guys. And those situations, that little detail, you've gotta work in, get control, get the stoppage.
So late in the period here, the Red Wings with an opportunity to salvage this opening stanza. White off with a trip at 18:44.
They saw a problem again. This time Datsyuk's going to get kicked out again after the puck has been dropped.
Zetterberg will take the draw against Scott Nicklin for the defensive zone faceoff on this penalty kill. Nicklin ends up falling on it. It's poked out, and Lindstrom will keep it in. Now the Wings power play. Shot blocked by Niemi. He's looking for it. He's got it.
That was a solid shot from the boards. And that hit Antti Niemi's pad with some sort of authority, but Antti Niemi with that right leg is just excellent at kicking it out, putting it right down on the ice.
And this faceoff moves to the other side now, so Nickel comes off, and Joel Thornton's gonna take the draw against Datsyuk.
It's been a matchup we've seen in the first two games for sure.
One by Detroit, Rafalski. He'll get it through to the front tip by Holmstrom. Zetterberg down behind the San Jose goal, tried to bank it out front. And Marlowe able to get to it in time and clear it the length of the ice. As we're under a minute left here in the first period, should the Red Wings fail to score here, there will be some carryover time.
Thomas Holmstrom and Mark-Edward Vlasic doing battle in front of the net and beside the net.
Datsyuk weaving his way into position. Hands it off to Zetterberg. Zetterberg checked by Boyle, who stole it. Now Dan Boyle trying to get it up the boards for Pavelski, but Holmstrom comes up with it instead to Zetterberg. To Datsyuk. Datsyuk with a man in front, sends it to the net. Blocked by Niemi. A chance in front for Lindstrom, and that's saved.
I think that went in.
The red light is on, and we've got a goal, and the Red Wings have tied it. So many bodies in front of the net, Drew. It was awfully hard to see, but Lindstrom knew it, and the goal judge knew it, too.
Well, the goal judge was a little late on this one. I think this is the great chance. Two saves, three saves by Antti Niemi, and then the turnaround by Henrik Zetterberg flips it back between the legs to Lindstrom. Lindstrom hits the back post, and he knows right away, and the referee counted it. And the Wings, with just 19.3 seconds, tie it up. Unfortunate for the Sharks. Great saves by Antti Niemi, but a mad scramble in front.
And they're going to check this, of course.
They'll have to go in the check.
But Nicklas Lidström, if this holds up, now has two of Detroit's three goals in this series. No question from what we believe that this is a good goal.
From the overhead, watch the camera in the back. Just going to go right into the back, hit the camera, right. There it comes. There it is. Right in the back.
So Nicholas Lidstrom, it's official now with his second goal of this series, 52nd of his Stanley Cup playoff career. Not bad for a defenseman. And the power play coming through for the Red Wings here as they tie it up late in period one. Mitchell to the net, but just wide. Picked up by Todd Bertuzzi with time running down. And we've come to the end of the opening 20 minutes. So indeed, the Red Wings do salvage things late on the power play goal by Nicholas Lidstrom from Zetterberg and Holmstrom at 19:38. That is it for the first period of Game 3. All tied up, the Sharks and the Red Wings, 1-1. We'll check in with Scott Reese and Brett Hedekin when we come back. And Brody Brazil checks in down in the Sharks dressing room.
Sharks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet California is brought to you by El Camino Hospital, Hospital of Silicon Valley.
Back live in Detroit as we get set to start the second period, all tied up at one. Well, Sharks fans, CSNCalifornia.com brings the game to life live on your laptop with in-game live. Follow the game online with enhanced player trackers, live Twitter feeds, and more, including Sharks Late Night Confidential. CSNCalifornia.com brought to you by El Camino Hospital, Hospital of Silicon Valley. Joe Thornton taking a little twirl. One of the statistics of note in that first period that sticks out, a couple of things. 17 hits for Detroit. I'm not sure about that. To four for San Jose. That seems a little bit over to three to San Jose. But no question about Pavel Datsyuk in the faceoff circle in that first period. As he was 71%, 1-5 out of 7. There's Nick Lidstrom passing Denny Potvin for all-time power play playoff goal.
Incredible.
There was a scoring change from that first period as well. Joe Pavelski getting the second assist on Devin Setoguchi's goal now, originally credited to Patrick Marleau. So for Pavelski, his second assist of this playoff, year 15th of his career. Second period underway here at the Joe. Douglas Murray stumbling as he tried to kick that puck up the boards, and the Red Wings right back on it. Dan Cleary, number 11, drops it for Zetterberg on this newly fashioned line by Mike Babcock. Brad Stewart skating in, tries to shovel it through all that humanity unsuccessfully as it's cleared out past center. And it's not just in this game, Drew. We're seeing it all over the league.
Yep.
The collapsing in front of nets and just so many bodies between puck carriers and goalies.
Yeah, absolutely. Everybody is deeming the front of the net for net play to be of ultra importance. And even the wingers are starting to get below the tops of the circles. Right into the slot they get sometimes.
This is Marc-Edouard Vlasic with a wrist shot that glances off the leg of Datsyuk, stays in the Sharks' possession. Now Heatley comes off the backboards with it with Ryan Clough. Heatley into the faceoff circle. Back over to Vlasic, and he got his stick on it. Then the follow shot by Couture goes up high.
Nice play, nice read by Marc-Edouard Vlasic, and Danny Heatley was just waiting. He knew Marc-Edouard was going to activate from the point because of all those people in front of the net. Couldn't take a direct shot, so he goes to the back door.
Good to see big number 15 out there to start the second period. Sometimes you'll see a player come out after a situation like that big hit by Cronwall and try to give it a go, which Heatley did at the end of the first period. Niemi with a save off Abdelkader, but Heatley out to start this second period as well as we go back and look at that last Sharks opportunity.
Danny Heatley waits. He's got that long reach, so it's very hard to get the puck off him. It was a good job by Marc-Edouard Vlasic to jump down the backside, but look who's there. Pavel Datsyuk is there in a defensive position and really took away a scoring chance or a better scoring chance for Marc-Edouard Vlasic. He might have put that one in.
Couture's follow chance wasn't bad either. He just got a little bit under it and shot it high over the net. Faceoff now in the Sharks zone. We're early here, period two. A 1-1 game and a pair of power play goals in the first period by Setoguchi and Lidstrom. This is Saleh, and that's blocked in front. Cronwall, Hudler, and knocked away with the blocker by Niemi. Abdelkader over to the boards. He's checked by Ballin. Puck comes out to Pavelski. Chipped ahead by Mitchell through the neutral zone, and Filppula back on it for the Red Wing. This is Yuri Hudler. He's got trouble with it. Ballin right there, but now the Sharks are going to have to back out of the zone. Pavelski lost an edge just as he was set to go off on a chain. Filppula. A little bit of speed through the neutral zone. Hands it off. Abdelkader's shot deflects up into the high glass. Rafalski from the right point. That hit Abdelkader comes through to Murray. Murray checked by Draper. Abdelkader there as well as Perio behind his own net trying to get that puck out of trouble. Draper back on it. Didn't play in the first two games. Back in the lineup for Detroit tonight, though, is number 33. As this one bounced off Murray. Back to the side. Helm trying to jam it through. Ferriero first blocks it. Then he gets his stick on it as it bounces back across. And Detroit coming on here in the early parts of this second period as Helm tries to take it off Mayers and does. Darren Helm in front. Eve's shot is blocked. And Nickel will play it up. And here's Jamal Mayers on a break down the right side. Erickson back defensively for the Red Wings. Pulls down Mayers. Mayers looks back at the referee, no penalty coming. Here's Marlowe, and that's checked off his stick by Helm. And Demers there to play it right back ahead for Mayers, who gets it deep.
Certainly seeing extra effort from both teams. Individuals and those one-on-one battles are so important.
Great pace here to game three so far. Nothing grinding about the style here. It's been heavy hitting, but some open ice as well, and the players are taking advantage of it when it comes. Here's Marlowe, and he lost the puck at the line to Cleary. Cleary handing it off to Zetterberg. Zetterberg turns it for a forehand shot at the side with Bertuzzi. Now Todd Bertuzzi. Waiting. Off to the side. Cleary's shot saved by Niemi. Sharks need to get a clear here. Setoguchi with a chance to do that, and he does just flick it out. Brad Stewart, though, pounds it right back in before the Sharks were able to get everybody off the ice. Setoguchi, he partially fans, then he's tripped by Zetterberg. No call right in front of the referee.
Look back at the referee, too.
Back comes Datsyuk. And the pass broken up nicely by Demers. Stays alive to Datsyuk. In the slot, fanning on it was Holmstrom as Klöv busts up the wing. He'll chip it in. Held up on his way to the puck to Chorgoth there, though, and now Heatley with it. At the line, waiting on it was Ian White, but good hand-eye by Datsyuk to break it up. Off the near boards, past Klöv through to Cronwall and on to Ruslan Salé. 4.5 down here in the second period, and the pace here is very, very quick. And Heatley dumps it around. Flow on this side of the ice, but the Red Wings have it. Not for long. Vallin punching it back toward Flow. And Ruslan Salé with it. Detroit out shooting the Sharks 16-12 at this juncture. Both teams with power play goals in the first period. Filppula chips to the boards for himself. Pavelski back around to Wellwood.
Aggressive.
Backhanded out.
Aggressive defense. I'm going to show you something the Red Wings are doing right here. Really interesting. Freeze it for a second, guys. Cleary's going to slide to the outside. Remember, we talked about all those bodies in front. And then you're going to get an activation from the point by Nick Lidstrom. So a lot of movement in trying to beat all those people who are standing in front. Lidstrom slides the middle. Cleary slides to the outside. So the Red Wings, to start off the second period, aren't jamming the front of the net. They're sliding to the outside and trying shots from different angles and then having the defenseman jump in for a rebound.
Thornton and Zetterberg settle in for this faceoff. Linesman Brian Murphy set to drop the puck, working with Greg Dvorsky. The other linesman referees tonight are Eric Furlatt and Mark Jonette. And Boyle with it on a faceoff win by the Sharks. Douglas Murray. Brings it in. Bertuzzi, though, boots it right back behind his net. Turn over to Marlon in front. Setoguchi with a couple of chances, but he fanned. And that leads a rush back the other way, 3-on-2. Zetterberg behind Bertuzzi. And now the Sharks come back ahead. Setoguchi to Thornton. Marlowe on the wing, and it's wide. Rebounds around. Late to the corner for Thornton. Now Lidstrom on it. He takes a hit from Marlowe as Zetterberg gets roughed up. Joe Thornton finishing his check down low. Brad Stewart. And he'll wrist it around to the weak side. Eve, though, gets on the puck. Had it, lost it. Couture just steers it ahead in time to Klöv. Ryan Klöv trying to get through the first line of defense. Does. Now working down low against Draper, who leans in hard on Ryan Klöv. Heatley, this will bounce free to Demers. Over to Vlasic. He'll wrist it off the boards. It pinballs right in front. Creates a chance here at the side for Klöv. Now Couture with it. He's run into by Cronwall.
Sharks are using those boards to their advantage.
Heatley And that's finally cleared by the Wings. Of course, the Sharks' goal came off a shot from the boards. Back down to Couture as this line still on for the Sharks and keeping it in the Detroit end for the most part. Couture checked by Stewart. Helm there to Mitchell as Couture still has the puck. At the point, White just unable to keep it in, but he kept it away from going further down and could have led to a Detroit break.
Absolutely. It was a really good play by Ian White.
Here is Pavel Datsyuk. Points in all three games of the series now for number 13. A scramble in front of Niemi. Diving down. That comes Wellwood the other way. Here's Pavelski across the line, and the wrist shot saved by Howard. Joe Pavelski gets his own rebound. Looks out front at Ferriero. Now it comes to Boyle. He waits, shoots, and Howard the glove save. Great action here in game three.
Damon Andrews with you from the Comcast Sportsnet studios. The Oakland Athletics will be taking on the Cleveland Indians tonight on Comcast Sportsnet Plus, which can be found on Comcast cable channels 410 and 780, DirecTV channel 699, Dish channel 451, and AT&T channel 768. Now, if you can't find Comcast Sportsnet Plus, log on to CSNCalifornia.com or call your local cable operator.
We talked about Joe Thornton at the start of the program. How has Joe Thornton changed? Well, I don't know if he's changed, but he's certainly evolved. Look at how hard he backtracks through the neutral zone, causes the turnover, and the Sharks go the other way, all because the captain of the San Jose Sharks started it with a terrific back check. Joe's attention to detail away from the puck is the biggest, if you can say, change in his game. I like to say evolution.
7 points in the playoffs so far for Jumbo Joe Thornton, as well as he got the primary assist on the power play goal back in the first period by Devin Setoguchi. There's Ben Ferriero into the feet of Howard, and it's loose. And a lot of traffic in front of him. Red Wings come out with the puck. Justin Abdelkader. Now Hudler knocked down, a shot to the net, saved by Niemi.
Everything's putting the puck on the net as much as they can from any angle.
Like the Sharks did in game one when they had 46 shots on Jimmy Howard. Out high to the blue line, and Erickson's pass shot is deflected out of play.
I like that play. There's lots of pushing and shoving. There's lots of bodies going to the net. There's guys just willing to go to those areas in order to score, and that's what you have to have in the playoffs. Obviously, you have to be willing to get the job done. Something Todd McClellan talks to his team about all the time as we look at the Red Wings brass. Todd McClellan has always talked about, yeah, we have the skill, we have the ability, but you have to be willing to do it. General manager Doug Wilson looks on.
As is the case with most organizations this time of year, pretty much everyone in the hockey department that normally wouldn't travel during the regular season is on hand here in the playoffs.
It's also the team brings a lot of different personnel as well. There's more demands in the playoffs, so you want to make sure all the players' needs are taken care of that they want for nothing. So you've got to put more staff in and around the team.
Including medical staff.
Yep.
Niemi with the glove save.
Well, that's important because you don't want your guys talking to their doctors, because we just talked about, you know, there is no mercy in the playoffs. If there's something wrong with the other guy that you know on the other team's got a bad ankle or something, you'll give it a little chop when you go by it.
Well, in the case of the Heatley situation earlier in the game, when he was checked by Cronwall, in a regular season situation when maybe a doctor would need to check him out or something, it would in fact be a Detroit doctor, but that's not the case here in the postseason. The Sharks, as we said, bring their own medical staff along, and they're not the only team to do that. Everybody does that. Coming up on the halfway point of this second period, and just like the rest of this series, it has been very compelling and low scoring.
Nice step in by Erickson to cut the puck off, and again the Sharks fail to clear.
And right back in comes Abdelkader, and Niemi will hang on to this and clean it up, as Joe Pavelski, I'm sure, is a little upset with himself on that last sequence. Want to do a better job of that than that of getting out of your end.
Sharks have been very good in the first two games at being able to clear the puck. Winger had good support. Sinman would come underneath. This was just a play that the first time that Erickson just jumps in on. And then the Sharks have a chance to clear it, and just Pavelski overskates it. And here's the advantage to the Red Wings. They get it, and they come right back at you. Turnovers will cause transition on a team as skilled as the Red Wings. So you want to make sure as much as you can to push that puck behind the wings, not in front of them.
Pavelski with a goal in game one. Now is four in these playoffs.
You know what? There's been a record for how many 19 overtimes so far this year in the NHL playoffs. Might be a record for how many times the linesmen have kicked guys out of the faceoff the circle.
Drop the puck.
Erickson to Helm, and that's off his stick. Back to the big defenseman, Jonathan Erickson, puts that on the net, and this trend continues here in the second period, at least, of Detroit just content, even in low percentage situations like that, of putting pucks at the net.
Well, the Sharks are trying to figure a way. Todd McClellan's trying to get his team to figure a way to get the puck behind the Detroit defense and have some offensive zone time of their own. Now, the Sharks have been giving up shots from well out, but continuing to get faceoff after faceoff in the zone for Detroit Red Wings is not something that Todd McClellan wants for his team. Obviously, they want the faceoffs on the other side.
Marlowe backhands it off the boards, but didn't have the angle on the pass for Boyle. And Lidstrom, Detroit's captain, hands it off to Todd Bertuzzi. We're live in the second period at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. The first of two games in this series here in Michigan after the Sharks took the first two in California. Here's a break up the middle for Setoguchi. Well defended by the forward Zetterberg, who was the last man back there.
I like the jump throw by Setoguchi right through the middle, and Joe Thornton, of course, with his unique passing abilities, threads the needle.
Zetterberg keeping it in. Bertuzzi, and that rebounds off Niemi. Back to Lidstrom. He flutters a shot that's blocked by Thornton. Now Boyle trying to get it clear. Can't. Cleary up to the front for Zetterberg. And his stick broken. And Setoguchi bangs it out of trouble. Red Wings seem to have a little more of the momentum right now over the last 4 or 5 minutes or so here in the second period. Niemi, like he did early in the first period, has come up big. Franzen, and that's off Murray's skate. Drops to the wings. Shot saved by Niemi. Loose in front, and Couture will get to it up to Heatley, and out it comes to Clough. Angling across is Niemi. Just kept it away from the big winger for the Sharks. Datsyuk on his backhand flips it in. Niemi with the read. Comes out to play it himself. Banks it off the glass, and it works out perfectly to Heatley with Couture across center. Heatley into the zone. Puts it off the blocker. There's Jimmy Howard. Couture following, trying to get it. It's Heatley with it. Up on the boards is White, but his quick pass back for Heatley intercepted. Datsyuk. As White stays with him, now Datsyuk puts on the brakes, quickly backhands a pass that deflects through to Heatley. Still 1-1 here in the second. Heatley gains the zone to Clough. He'll send it deep.
Long chip.
Now behind the net, Pavelski with Heatley, who's tripped up. Pavelski with a skate over the puck. Saleh and Rapalski trying to dig it out. And the Red Wings come up with it. Coppola to Yuri Hudler. Mitchell comes in. Knock Rapalski off it. Big battle in the neutral zone there. Wallin against Hudler. Wraps him up. Ian White up the boards for Wellwood. He'll flick it off and out of play from the tip.
Off the glass.
Faceoff will stay in the San Jose zone. We'll break. 8:34 left in a tie. 1-1 game in the second.
Back here live at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Still tied at one. And yes, it is that time of the year where all of the Sharks players and even some of the outrageous broadcasters, yeah, that's right, growing playoff beards. But this time around, it's all for a very good cause. Because you can log on to beardathon.com/sharks to make your own profile and, of course, pledge a donation. Now, all the proceeds go towards the Sharks Foundation, which so far has totaled almost $14,000. Once again, beardathon.com/sharks, where you'll find Sharky, Logan Couture, and Devin Setoguchi. Those guys right there in the lead. Randy, there's still time for you and I, though, to catch up.
I don't know if I can catch up to Brody's beard. There's Jimmy Howard. There's a beard somewhere underneath his mask. He's been solid at the Detroit end of the ice with 15 saves. Niemi's been busier, 21 saves for the Sharks goaltender.
And we've seen this period, Detroit just firing the puck from all angles, being able to push the puck behind the Sharks D and really control most of the second period.
And they win the faceoff. Here's Filppula gets the draw back to the point. Wide with the shot. Hudler wants Abdelkader. The two number eights battle behind the net. Abdelkader played it out, but Mitchell's there, the recipient of it. Now Mitchell working this side of the ice. Makes a nice play on the boards. Wellwood for Pavelski behind the net. He's against Filppula. Pavelski creates some room for himself. Now looking to make a play, but Filppula right on him. Pavelski still with it. Out front, Mitchell fans on his first effort. Now gets it deep again, and Pavelski over to Wellwood.
Nice move.
Kyle Wellwood on his backhand. Now Pavelski back to the point. Demers for Mitchell. Starts with a quick change here while the puck's relatively deep. In comes Setoguchi, fresh off the bench. Out to Demers, to the front of the net. Joe Thornton turns, can't get a shot away. And Abdelkader played it to the line. Not out initially, but now Rafalski ensures that it's clear. And Hudler will drive it in.
Decent offensive pressure, though, by the Sharks. Starts off by that Pavelski line.
Classic, wristing it in hard. Nobody touched it for San Jose. It doesn't matter. Morrow's first on it down the right side as Thornton and he work behind the net. Puck popped out of there to Cleary. He'll lift it up for Todd Bertuzzi. He knocks it down to Zetterberg. Henrik Zetterberg moves in on Douglas Murray's side of the ice, and Murray with the block. Nicely done by number three for the Sharks as he feeds the rush. Marlow at center. Setoguchi for Thornton. Trailing is Boyle, and his backhander off the net. As the pace picks up again, they go end-to-end here for a couple of shifts. Cleary, and that's blocked by Murray. Scott Nickel, he'll lob it towards center. Cronwall just backs away from pressure. All the scoring in this game in the first period, both goals on the power play as Murray has to settle a bouncing puck up for Ben Ferriero. Back to Cronwall, diagonally to Saleh. Eames slides it into the corner. Sharks, good communication, but then the puck ends up at the net anyway. Cronwall keeps it in at the point. Chip pass off the boards for Draper. Shovels it to Eaves. Eaves back to Helm. Helm gets away from his check, and at the side they score. Patrick Eaves with a backhand goal, and Detroit leads 2-1.
Done behind the net and the corners. The speed of Helm really creates that great quickness by Helm to get to the front of the net, and then just a missed puck. It's bad luck for the Sharks on the missed puck, but Helm steps out. Nickel misses the puck, and Eaves almost fans on the puck. But as Eaves dropped it back from the corner, he went to the front of the net, and Helm's speed and quickness just beat Dan Boyle behind the net to the front of the net.
So for only the second time in this series, the Red Wings have the lead. They scored the first goal of the series in game one. Patrick Eaves, his third of this playoff year. 2-1 Detroit. 15:59 time of the goal.
Shows you know, this game is a matter of inches, being at the right place at the right time, having the right timing, or having your stick in the right position. Scott Nickel just misses that puck from going to Eaves, but Eaves was smart, came out of the corner right back to the front of the net. And boy, with Helm, just quick. I mean, Helm just made that whole thing happen because of his speed, his quickness to create that space from Boyle, pull away from Boyle and get to the front.
Helm gets the primary assist. Chris Draper, in his first appearance in the series, gets the second assist. His third goal.
Rafalski is going to get a penalty for interference. So the Sharks get a power play opportunity. This could be a great opportunity for the Sharks to get back in the game. A power play going to San Jose because of Rafalski interference along the boards.
So the Sharks will be on the man advantage when we come back.
Rafalski takes a penalty, but it was just after the Detroit Red Wings scored a big goal. Second goal of the game for the Red Wings. Great speed by Helm coming. coming out. He tries to go to the front of the net and make a pass. Instead, he loses it. Scott Nickel just can't get the stick in the passing lane. And Ease comes to the front, backhands it. Doesn't get a lot on, but he gets enough to get it past Antti Niemi, who scrambled from one side to the other. And right after that, Logan Couture interfered with by Brian Rafalski. The Sharks get a power play opportunity.
Third power play of the game for San Jose. Sharks 1-for-2 on the goal by Setoguchi in the first. Boyle to a wide open Pavelski to Marlowe, and he couldn't get a stick on it as Howard was down. Good puck recovery in the neutral zone by the Sharks as Marlowe got it away from Datsyuk. But now Pavelski forced to play it deep. Under 5.5 left here in the second period. Detroit with the lead. As Pavelski enters to Thornton. Back for Boyle. Reaches back. The shot by Setoguchi scores! Devin Setoguchi with an off-speed shot that fooled Howard. And we're tied again.
You're a home run hitter. You're thinking the heater is coming. And I'm talking Danny Heatley. You think the fastball is coming. And play goes from the top to the circle, and Howard thinks the fastball's coming. Instead, it's a changeup, a fan shot that Howard just absolutely overplays, misses, and it's got perfect accuracy, and Devin Setoguchi scores another one, and the Sharks tie it up on the power play.
Pavelski right in front, creating a distraction as well for Jimmy Howard. But no question about it, Howard bit on what he thought would be a hard shot, and it ended up being anything but that. But it ends up in the back of the net, and the Sharks are 2-for-2 on the power play, and they've tied this up on Setoguchi's second of the game. Another shot through. Rebound, Couture trying to find an opening behind Howard. It stays alive to Logan Couture. His pass for Heatley broken up, and the Wings chip it clear to center ice. Clough makes a hit from Datsyuk, gets it down the board. Saleh just beat Couture to that puck. Good forecheck put on there by Heatley. But the Wings able to come out of their end. Heatley, though, back on it in the neutral zone. This is Filppula across to Erickson. Up ice at center. Here's a break for Filppula, but he mishandled the puck. Sharks on a bad change here. Filppula to Saleh, and he hit the top of the crossbar, I believe.
I think
he
got a piece of Niemi in the crossbar.
Here's Filppula again. Quick momentum shifts in this game. Just when you think one team's got it, the other team takes it back. Hudler sets up. A slap pass over to the far side for Filppula. And Wellwood bangs it up to Pavelski, who tries to fight his way through Saleh. Can't. In comes Abdelkader. Hands it off to Hudler. Gary Hudler to the front of the net. That was dangerous. Zetterberg from the angle, and it bounces to the blue line. A shot by Cronwall, blocked in front. And Pavelski back across to Marlowe with speed. Cuts in around Rafalski. Marlowe at the boards, kept wide by Cronwall. And it goes right up the gut to Bertuzzi, who's just on the ice on a line change. He'll flip it ahead. Bertuzzi held up by Setoguchi. And the Red Wings will get a penalty. But first, a scoring chance in front for Zetterberg. And now it's controlled, and we'll get the call. Holding is the call against Devin Setoguchi.
Well, let's go back. Devin Setoguchi, the center of attention. Here's the shot. Hits way too much ice. Just beats Jimmy Howard on the ultramote cam. And here is the holdup. Oh, okay. It's all I'm missing. It's okay.
So Devin Setoguchi, in the middle of a lot of what's gone on here in game two from the San Jose standpoint, he has both goals, and now he sits in the penalty box for holding at 16:33 with the Red Wings trying to do what the Sharks have done, and that scored twice on the power play.
Obviously, this is a critical moment in the hockey game in this second period because the San Jose Sharks are able to bounce back on a power play to tie the game up. The Wings scored late in the first period on the power play.
Setoguchi's goal, just to recap, was his third of these playoffs, 10th career. Boyle and Thornton with the assist, so Joe Thornton's been in on both Sharks power play goals tonight. Here is the Red Wing power play. They are 1-for-2 on the goal by Lidstrom back in the first. And a good start on the penalty kill. Howard leaves it behind his net, and Brian Rafalski will skate it up for the Wing. Into the feet of Hudler, and that breaks it up for the moment. Now retrieved by Johan Franzen. Alleen fell, but he's supported by Pavelski along the boards, and Logan Couture will put it on net from in his own zone.
Good support by Logan Couture. Actually, really good work by Pavelski helping Alleen out as well as the Sharks try to pressure the wings as immediately as they enter the zone.
Good stretch, and now Franzen into the slot, but he couldn't get a shot away. And Mitchell has Marlowe 2-on-1. Mitchell to Marlowe, and it's poked away by Rafalski, who played that perfectly.
Hard not to want to give the pass to Patrick Marleau in that situation. You know, it's Patrick Marleau, so you want to try to feed the puck as much as you can to him. Troy Mitchell coming up. He's looking across all the way. He doesn't get enough on that pass. He's trying to feather it. Rafalski with the good stick. Knocks it down. But the Sharks did a nice job out of the, in their own zone to make that play out of the zone. Again, good support in the middle of the ice by the Sharks forwards.
Still a minute 10, as you see, left on this Detroit power play as we're down to 2.5 minutes here in the third. Joe Thornton tripped up in the faceoff circle after the draw is won by Detroit. Nicholas Lidstrom just lost the puck for a moment there, and that breaks up the entry. And Lidstrom has it again. Rare to see number 5 mishandled it in that manner. Happens in the best of families, though. Holmstrom, Thornton working hard up at the point. Now the shot, the save by Niemi, and Vlasic pulled it off the goal line.
Yes, he did.
Here's Datsyuk, and he lost it. Good play by Thornton to get it down.
Much like Pavel Datsyuk in game 2, Mark-Edward Vlasic with a game-saving play. Or at least a goal-saving play.
Back comes Zetterberg. He's away from Boyle, right to the middle. Datsyuk scores.
We talked about Pavel Datsyuk at the start. Zetterberg brings 2 guys to him, and there's Pavel Datsyuk.
Might have been off Holmstrom.
I think Holmstrom was in there to bother Niemi enough, but what happens when Zetterberg comes in, like Datsyuk, he'll draw players to him. And as he draws the players to him, he flips it to the open Datsyuk, hitting the seam at the right time. And he squeezes through that shot past Antti Niemi, and Datsyuk continues his point streak against the Sharks.
Power play's gone wild here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. 2 power play goals for the Red Wings, 2 for the Sharks. As Todd McClellan had a word with the referee just a moment ago. And we'll wait for the official scoring play, but all indications are that it is Pavel Datsyuk's goal. And it is Datsyuk, his 3rd of this playoff year. Now we're down to 1.5 minutes here in the second period. The sellout here at Joe Louis Arena is enjoying this one. Back comes Heatley. In comes Couture. Checked by Cronwall. Heatley along the backboards. And it's poked from his feet to Coppola. A little interference run there behind the play by Saleh, but he got away with it. Here's Vlasic holding off Detroit's nice. Number 44, Bertuzzi.
Really good work by Mark-Edward Vlasic. It's calming things down.
1 minute to go here in the second period. Datsyuk's goal. The assist to Zetterberg and Lindstrom at 18-17. This is Lindstrom. Up the gut to Zetterberg. Red Wings. One of those teams, when they smell blood, want to seize the moment. Here as they'll try and get another one, and Datsyuk fan.
And Mark-Edward again.
This is Ryan Clough. Down out of his glove. Puck caroms directly to Zetterberg. He'll go cross ice to Franzen. Checked by Vallin. Deep and around behind the net. Ian White with it for the Sharks. He'll move to the middle. Nice skating move. Then he backhands it to center for Thornton, who's got Marlow. Slides it down the boards for him. Grant Stewart back, but Marlow had body position. Thornton with a pass that caroms to White. Back to Joe Thornton. Late here in the second period. Thornton trying to force one to the middle, and that didn't work. Back come the Wings. And a break for Draper, but time runs out. And fortunately for the Sharks, it did.
Good period by the Detroit Red Wings. The Sharks able to bounce back, but gave up a power play again late in the period. Going to need a big third period by San Jose.
The Red Wings will have a lead going into the third for the first time in this series. They're ahead 3-2 after two. Scott and Brett back in the studio in just moments to break down period number two here in Detroit. Former Shark Brian Campbell.
No, that's not Brian Campbell. That's a Red Wings fan here in Detroit, where the Red Wings lead the Sharks 3-2 after two periods of game two. And these fans here in Detroit hoping their dominance on home ice comes through for them tonight as we get out of Brody Brazil with Matt Shaw, assistant coach.
Coach, 20 minutes left in this game. Enough time for one, maybe two goals, but how high is the urgency level for this team to get started early in the period?
Well, the biggest urgency we need to have is have our game going the right way. We can be a little sharper. They've picked their game up a little bit. We've done some things that hasn't gone with them. So that's our urgency right now. We do that, it gives ourselves a chance.
Coach, thank you.
You bet.
Randy and Drew back upstairs.
There's Devin Setoguchi. He's on a roll in this building, isn't he? The last time the Sharks were here in the regular season was February 22nd. They beat the Red Wings 4-3. In fact, they swept both games here, the other one 5-2 back in December. But Setoguchi had two goals in that game. And now he has both goals for the Sharks tonight as Antiniemi prepares for the start of this third period. Setoguchi having a word with referee Eric Furlatt at center ice.
Obviously about that holding penalty that he was hit with in the second that led to the Datsyuk goal.
Well, to those of you watching who are looking for the A's game against the Indians, that's airing right now on CSN Plus on the channels listed on your screen. Visit CSN California for more information on the Indians and the A's tonight.
Lots of options for you.
This wouldn't be a bad place to stay either, though, as we head to the third period now. Another one-goal game, although by comparison to the first two games of this series, this one's wild. We've had five goals, a total of only three in each of the first two games in San Jose.
High scoring, relatively speaking, I guess.
And the third period underway here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. We'll see if the San Jose Sharks can battle back and get it even and continue their effort to try and take a 3-0 lead in this series. Thornton, Marlowe, back for Joe Thornton. And his shot saved by Jimmy Howard is some nice interchange there between Thornton and Marlowe.
Again, just roll this, guys. Watch for the stretch. Just roll this, guys, as they set up behind the net. Go ahead, roll it, roll it, roll it. All they're going to do is just stretch out of the zone. Look how you've got two guys, four guys back in the Detroit zone, but then they just take off out of the zone. You've already got the man high at the offensive blue line, which is the Sharks' blue line. Then they blow another guy right out the middle, so Lidstrom just standing back and making a long pass. Pushes the defense back, creates some open space.
Bronson will take Datsyuk's spot in the faceoff circle. And Couture wins the draw back to Heatley, back to Vlasic, over to Heatley once more. Off his stick, and he'll have to push it to the corner. Couture there. Klo trying to get to it ahead of Cronwall as Couture has it again on this side now. It's a rough ride along the boards from Bronson. Shot from the line by Demers.
Just missed. Logan Couture, I think, got a piece of that puck.
Datsu tripped up in the neutral zone. Play goes on, and the fans here thought a call might be coming. Vlasic taking his time with a minute gone here in period three. Couture with Heatley, and his shot saved by Howard. The big rebound off the boards. As Pilppula weaves his way partly around Mitchell, but Mitchell keeps it in the zone for now. And both teams change up across the ice. The veteran Ruslan Saleh stolen up near the line by Pavelski, but he couldn't move ahead with it. As Niemi sets it up behind his net over to Nicholas Wallin. Pavelski looking for the pass from Mitchell. It deflected off of a Red Wing. Deep into Detroit territory. Pavelski into Mitchell. He had the puck all alone and he fanned. What a chance for Mitchell. 3-on-2 back the other way. Rafalski pounds it to the net. Saved by Niemi. The rebound. A couple of whacks by Abdelkader. Back to the point. Rafalski waits. Passes. And it's blocked by a San Jose stick and cleared off the near glass. Although just barely as it hit one of the stanchions on Olwood's effort to bank it up ice.
Glorious chance for Torrey Mitchell. Just fanned on it. Just missed the puck.
Now Henrik Zetterberg. His first two assists of these playoffs have come in this game. Marlow to Setoguchi. Devin trying to flick it up for Thornton. He's watched by Stewart. Thornton just missing keeping it in as it's pounded in and around by Douglas Murray to Nicholas Lidstrom's side of the ice. Detroit goals in this game by Lidstrom, Eaves, and Datsyuk. Two of them on the power play. Setoguchi has both San Jose goals, both on the power play. And he has the puck now to Marlow. Back in for Devin Setoguchi. He'll leave it in the corner. Couture there. Pass out for Demers, and he heals it.
That was a little bit into his feet. But the Sharks activating a little bit more.
Here's Heatley now with Couture and Clough. Across. Vlasic settles it. Brings it around. Tried to bank it in off Howard. No goal.
Nice idea. Really good play by Howard.
Good back check by Clough, and it causes an offside.
Sharks looking better. Ryan Clough's upset. There's no call by the official on what he deemed would have been a hooking penalty. Good play off the forecheck. Torrey Mitchell just has that puck behind him. You can't sweep it towards the net. This is what Ryan Clough's unhappy with, is the grab of the stick by Dan Cleary that he thinks is a penalty. Nobody else is buying it.
Jimmy Howard's made 19 saves. Down to the other end, Niemi with 24. As Detroit out shooting the Sharks and threatening to finish the game that way for the first time in this series. San Jose with the shot advantage up to this point. Big rebound off Niemi. And a chance for Helm, but he saw it too late. Then he fell. That allows the Sharks to come up ice. Wellwood to Pavelski with Wallin. His shot saved by Howard. Rafalski. Trying to flip it up for the speedy Darren Helm, but Ian White's back, and he's got the angle on Helm, but he couldn't get the puck from him. Here's Helm looking to make a play. White stays with it. Cutting in is Franza. He can't get around the defense. It was White making the play, and now Wallin settles it down just a bit. And Wellwood with a nice move in the neutral zone, but Rafalski's back on it for the Red Wings. We've played 4 minutes in the third period. It's a 3-2 Detroit lead. As Demers gets his stick on a pass through the middle, it ends up as a 2-on-1. Franzen with Holmstrom. Franzen shot just wide and then off the rebound. Niemi made the save. Franzen back to Cronwall. He'll shoot it. And it's blocked up high by Couture. Now Datsyuk lost it to Vlasic. Headband up for Danny Heatley. Now Couture takes it off his skate and he's onside. Wrists it across. Clough shoots and it's blocked by the diving Holmstrom. Heatley and Clough for San Jose as Heatley fell. And now Thomas Holmstrom picks it up for Detroit. Nicholas Cronwall delivering a big hit in the first period of this game to the Sharks' Danny Heatley, who left for a while, missed a few shifts in the Sharks' dressing room. Only to return, obviously. Here's a 3-on-2. Thornton shoots high. Rebound, Marlow. It's a round pass, Thornton. Wallin, or make it Murray, will gamble and made the right play as he got to it ahead of Zetterberg. But now the Red Wings on second effort get it back. Lidstrom holding off a couple of back checkers. And Zetterberg through the middle. Ran into opposition. Puck drops to Todd Bertuzzi. He'll change sides to Cleary. Zetterberg stranded in the zone, so Cleary could only dump it in.
Well, Zetterberg and Joe Thornton got tied up along the boards. Joe Thornton went down, looked back at the referee for an interference call again, did not get it.
Here's Pavelski off his stick. Almost worked out to Wellwood. Cleared back to the neutral, and Hudler hanging around there is able to get it to Filppula. That's cleared up Ben Ferriero's way, but back on the stick of Erickson. Now Hudler with some speed. Lays it off on the wing. Abdelkader's shot saved by Niemi. Rebound on the stick of Ian White to Wellwood. He gives it up to Filppula. Back in come the Wings. Now Filppula, checked by Boyle, has Abdelkader behind the net. He's watched by Ian White. Goes to the point. They change sides to Erickson. He'll play it off those active boards. Abdelkader reading that. He ties up with White. Ends up with the puck from the angle. Wellwood trying to get it to the Sharks. He was tripped up, and it's going to be a Red Wing minor penalty. So the Sharks will have a chance to tie it up on the power play when we come back.
I'm Jim Cosimo in the Comcast Sportsnet studios. If you're looking for the Oakland A's game, you can see that over on CSN Plus. Please check your local provider. Tonight, the A's at home taking on the Cleveland Indians, and a pair of 4-0 pitchers get the start. Trevor Cahill going for the A's against Josh Tomlin. He's also 4-0 right now. A's and Tribe, bottom of the first, no score. You can see it on CSN Plus.
Yuri Hudler in the penalty box. He gets his stick tangled up, gets parallel to the ice. Kyle Wellwood is twisted around. Penalty to Hudler. Sharks on the power play.
Where they have both of their goals tonight, as you see Hudler in the penalty box. Devin Setoguchi out there, and he has scored those two power play goals. Sharks with four power play goals in the series thus far. Matsuk on the faceoff. Wynn Cronwall gets it past Pavelski. It's the classic way you want to start on your penalty kill if you're the Red Wings. Dan Boyle now drops it for Thornton. And Thornton able to keep it alive. Back to Setoguchi now. He and Marlowe down low. Setoguchi shot block. Pavelski changing the angle. Saved by Howard. And the puck loose in front of him. He finds it.
Well, the Red Wings fail to clear, and the Sharks get a scoring chance out of it, but you got to get to the front of the net. We've talked about that pretty much this entire playoff series. As this play goes out to Pavelski, the Sharks not anxious or urgent enough to get to the front of the net. You've got to be moving right away, thinking when that puck goes out to the point, you got to get to the front to distract the goaltender.
Couture now against Draper. Joining us late, Chris Draper into the lineup for the first time in this series tonight in place of Drew Miller. Heatley. And Draper gets tossed.
Tossed two out now. He's tossed Couture and Draper up. Heatley and Datsyuk.
Heatley stick down first, and that one executed correctly and won by the Red Wings. A minute 20 left now on the San Jose power play. Jason Demers shoots it in. Trouble. Rebound. And it's shot high.
And it was up off the netting, too. That was a troubled shot for Jimmy Howard to handle. A long shot that produces a huge rebound. Jason Demers shoots it. It deflects off of the defenseman. And there's the rebound opportunity. The defenseman was who? Is that Brad Stewart? It was Brad Stewart. Just deflected off his pad. That's why Howard had to react so quickly to it. But Logan's rebound opportunity goes high. And you notice the Sharks on their rebound chances are going high all the time.
That puck might have been spinning a bit, yeah, too, when Couture shot it.
Had some jump on it.
Couture with the faceoff, and now Ian White. He's been a point producer for sure in this playoff year for the Sharks. Shot from the blue line, and that's blocked. Demers had it deflected. Could keep in by White.
Great.
But good second effort by Helm, and now he'll break down the left wing. Helm puts on the brakes. Goes across for Eaves. And back to Saleh. Williams didn't get a chance there, but they killed some precious time off the clock. Now down to 40. And this is Pavelski. Clean entry. Thornton back for Boyle. On the wing, the shot saved by Howard. He reaches back, but he's got it. Devin Setoguchi, he's shooting everything tonight. Why not?
He should be. Good entry into the zone. Devin Setoguchi set up on the off wing for the one-timer. Drills it. Almost the same spot he scored his second goal from. This time, though, Jimmy Howard expected the fastball and got it.
getting more and more pucks to the net here in the third period. It's their seventh shot on goal of the period. Marlowe to the front. Here's Pavelski, kept in at the line toward the net, and Brad Stewart able to sort it out. He's checked by Marlowe, but Datsyuk there to clear it out. Lots down to 10 left.
Lots of pucks getting knocked down on their way to the net.
Thornton into Marlowe. He'll get it deep. Pavelski there, so is Cronwall. Puck out to the side. Thornton trying to jam it in. No room.
Good play by Pavelski behind the net.
Setoguchi. And Helm takes it off him, and then Setoguchi falls. Here's a 3-on-2 for Detroit. Zetterberg with Hoedler. And broken up, but in front again. And Niemi with a save right off Hoedler. Wellwood lobbing it up to center, but no further, and that allows Hoedler to come right back in with it. Back to 5-on-5 now, with 11-10 left in the third. Dan Cleary for Hoedler. He gets away from a check by Wellwood, all the way out to Rafalski at the point. That's off the boards, pushed aside by Niemi, but the Red Wings right back on it. Zetterberg leaves it for Lidstrom. Back to Zetterberg. Henrik Zetterberg's pass blocked by the skate of Dan Boyle.
Dan Boyle was on him like a shadow. There's no way he was shaking Boyle. Even Boyle got interfered with a little bit at the off or the top of the blue line. He still stayed with Zetterberg, got back in position quickly.
Terrific game here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Game 3 of this best of 7. San Jose, a year ago, took a 3-0 lead in the series here in Detroit. Now they're down by a goal here in the third as it's forced into their zone again. Marc-Edouard Vlasic to Danny Heatley. Holmstrom holding up Heatley, able to clear it back out. Both teams changing on the fly. Marlowe on the far side. Bertuzzi. And Ferriero cuts in to keep it alive to Thornton. Joe Thornton working behind the goal line, hands it off to Ben Ferriero, the hero in game one. He's checked by Bertuzzi. And now Zetterberg moves in, turns back, and dumps it in. Niemi, trouble behind the net. Bertuzzi gets it there, but Niemi recovered in time.
Just some excitement for you. Wow.
We'll be back at Joe Louis Arena. In Detroit, time for Subway Ask the Crew. The sports guy from Modesto setting in a question tonight. What is your favorite Sharks playoff moment? Well, tough to pick one, Drew.
Last year, Dan Boyle, after a disastrous Game 3, he starts the scoring off for the Sharks in Game 4. I thought that was a great moment.
Kevin Setoguchi this year.
Unbelievable. That one of the biggest comebacks in NHL history.
Last year, Game 3, Marlowe in overtime. Sharks went on to win the series, but that was a key moment for sure. But this is still my favorite. Jamie Baker, Game 7 here at Joe Louis Arena back in 1994 as the 8th seed Sharks shocked the hockey world, upsetting the Red Wings.
I think that entire playoff was my favorite moment of Sharks playoff history because it was brand new, it was exciting, and like you said, the Sharks shocked the world.
Nothing like the first time. And a half to go here in the third period, and the Red Wings nursing a one-goal lead. Douglas Murray back over to his defense partner Dan Boyle. It's steered in by Thornton. He tried to work it to the point. Zetterberg broke it up, then passed it right into Cleary. Brad Stewart now for Detroit. He'll gain the zone and just get it in and get off. Murray off the boards. Nicely executed to Ben Ferriero, but then he's checked by Erickson, and it's back to Jason Demers at center. Ben Ferriero, the game winner in overtime in game one. First Shark to score an overtime goal in the playoffs in his first game since Nico Dimitrakos did it against the St. Louis Blues back in 2004.
Nico Dimitrakos.
Icing waved off here as Vlasic controls it for San Jose.
Sharks are looking for another playoff hero. 8:15 left to go. Trying to take a stranglehold on this series.
Demers to Pavelski. Skates in, shot it wide through the blue paint. Back out it comes to Vlasic. Under eight now as Couture gives it right back to number 44.
He's been almost all San Jose this period.
Heatley. And Howard can't reach that. Klo will try to on the far side. With Couture, the shot from the side, and Howard made the save just barely. Ian White carries it to the corner where he's knocked off the puck. Couture's got it at the blue line. Logan Couture fires, and Howard the save.
Very good forecheck. Good aggressive move by White to keep the puck in. And the Sharks continue to push. 29 shots they have now. They've really overtaken the shot clock in this period. Shot from a good angle. Sharks on the forecheck. Logan Couture taking the spot of Ian White. He keeps the puck in. White forced the play. Logan was waiting for more traffic to get to the front of the net. But Howard was able to sniff that one out and stop it cold.
10-7, the third period shots in favor of the Sharks. Thornton into the corner, but Setoguchi can't get to it. Thornton will. Back around for Devin Setoguchi. He's had the hot hand with two goals. Rips this one right into Lidstrom skates. And now Cleary will skate it up. Wallin. He's hooked. Ian White goes to Thornton across ice with a hard pass. And Thornton will get it deep for a line change. 7 minutes left here in the third. Zetterberg to Patrick Eves, who has one of the Detroit goals tonight. Murray, nice play against Zetterberg. Up for Couture. Chips it past Cronwall, but Draper coming back has it for Detroit to Saleh. Draper back in again deep. And he's got a step on Murray. Chris Draper with the puck. Settles it for Cronwall, but that came out of the zone. And an offside whistle with 6.5 left here in the third.
Chris Draper shows you why he can be inserted in the lineup at any time. Speed, just fast. Top of cone changes the lines. I think the Sharks' shift lengths have been better this period. They've been better at managing the puck. Mike Babcock sees that his team is now sitting back and just trying to defend that one goal lead. I think Matt Shaw was right. They need to get their game going in the right direction, and now they're trying to push for that tying goal. Just need some solid shifts. Right now, it's, you hear players talk about it, it's just a matter of looking across and trying to beat the guy you're up against. And those one-on-one battles are so important late in the game.
Here's Pavelski at center. Gets into the zone, and it's cleared back out again. Angling across is Vlasic.
Vlasic and Datsyuk were tied up in the neutral zone with each other.
Rafalski on his horse to recover this for Detroit. Played it around, sealed off on the boards by Wellwood, who got it to Demers. Franzen can't get it out. Vlasic will shoot it. Saved by Howard, and it drops right for him to cover up. The Sharks keep the pressure on here in the third. Time for our Toyota game summary here in Detroit. Game 3, first goal scored by the Sharks. Devin Setoguchi on the power play in the first period. But then the Red Wings also on the power play tie it up. Nicholas Lidstrom off the back bar and in. As you see, it hit the camera actually. 1-1, and then in the second period, Patrick Eves with the backhander to beat Niemi. 2-1 Detroit. Sharks come back again, though, on the power play. Setoguchi again, 2-2. And still in the second period, one more power play goal. That one from Pavel Datsyuk. And that's where we stand. A scoreless third period so far. We know that guy. That's Kid Rock.
Detroit native, big Detroit Red Wings fan. Enjoying it here, sitting amongst the people.
He's a man of the people, Kid Rock.
Can you keep calling him Kid nowadays? Like, I mean, he's not much of a kid anymore.
Middle-aged guy Rock doesn't quite have the same ring to it.
Yeah, you're right. You're right. Older guy Rock, no, you're right.
Here's Dan Cleary, and he shoots it up into the screen behind Antti Niemi.
That was right off the faceoff in the Detroit Red Wings zone. The Red Wings able to get a breakout going. Pavel Datsyuk just took off out of the zone. And that's worked for the Red Wings tonight to clear the puck out of their own zone to create some space. They just fit stretch guys all night.
At what point in the game, Drew, if you're the Sharks, do you deviate a little bit from the plan and open it up a little bit to try and get the tying goal?
I don't think you have to yet. I think they like the way that the period is going pretty much. They've done a pretty good job of putting the puck and managing the puck in the defensive, in the offensive zone. Look out here, though.
Here's Zetterberg. He's got Cleary going to the net hard, and Wallin with his glove broke it up.
Good play by Nicholas Wallin.
Pass up the middle for Marleau, intercepted and slammed right back in by Brad Stewart.
And they're trying to deviate there a little bit. Randy kind of pushing it up the ice quicker than they have to, and it's getting cut off by the Red Wings because they're all sitting back in the neutral zone.
Clove. Back to Pavelski at center. He'll put it on net. Game four of this series back here in Detroit on Friday night, and the Wings hoping that they'll then have a chance to tie the series up 2-2, but we've still got 5 minutes to play in the third period of this one. As Clough weaves through some traffic.
All five Red Wings back.
Ryan Clough still on it. Trying to get it deep.
Outside.
And we're going to come back outside the zone on this faceoff.
That's the one thing that you're facing right now with the Detroit Red Wings. They are keeping all of their bodies in front of the San Jose Sharks, in front of the puck. So it's pretty hard to weave your way through the neutral zone and create any speed on the attack. Just now you got to get to the line and get simple. Get it deep, go to work. And really, when you hear any coach talk in the playoffs, that's all they talk about. Pucks behind.
32-31, the shots in favor of Detroit as the Sharks have put on a big offensive push here in the third. Mitchell, who had a great chance earlier in the period, gets it in behind the net, is Eves. He'll almost turn it over.
Gee, that was close.
What a chance that would have been. The Sharks would have had Detroit outnumbered deep.
Pavelski with the puck.
Now Mitchell. Cuts, shoots, saved by Howard. Rebound to Wellwood. Centers it. Boyle scores! Dan Boyle ties the game.
Well, Danny Boyle, sign of a great player. On the goal that was Patrick Eves, Danny had a tough time behind the net, but he makes up for it. Good entry into the zone, and the Sharks with their puck recovery. That's been a strong point of theirs the whole time. What a play by Kyle Wellwood. This whole series, Kyle Wellwood has been making plays and making plays. Danny Boyle, his instincts kick in, his offensive instincts. Second to none on the Sharks, walks in, even takes the time to wait, lets Howard go down, gets it up over the glove, and the Sharks have tied it up with just 4:08 left. Got ourselves a hockey game. This has been a good one since the get-go.
For Dan Boyle, his first goal of these playoffs, eighth of his Stanley Cup career. And it's 3-3, under 4 minutes left. Here's Thornton. Cleared off his stick up to Bertuzzi, who's checked by Demers. And Vlasic now keeps it away from Zetterberg. Thornton on the near boards, wanted Setoguchi, comes right back to Joe. And they just do stay onside, thought it might have been off. Marleau pokes it away from the reach of Brad Stewart, but Henrik Zetterberg starts up for Detroit. Sharks with a line change up ice. They have it executed in time as Zetterberg weaves his way in. Couture to get it past the referee. And that one's just cleared out. Fired back in by Saleh, and Ian White will settle things.
Johan Franzen was a whisker away from grabbing that puck that went through the middle of the ice.
White drives it in. It deflected off a Detroit stick that slows it down. Saleh able to get to it. And now the Red Wings 4-on-3 up ice. And it's Datsyuk across center. Drops it back from the point. Here's Cronwall. From the Sharks, Wallin has lost his stick. Saleh driving it around. Sharks need a clear here so Wallin can get his stick. Saleh winds up, shoots it wide. Kept in by Franzen at the point.
Big battle in front of the net.
Here's Saleh. Saved by Niemi. Sharks can't clear. Down low. In front. Holmstrom couldn't pick up the pass, but Detroit keeps the pressure on.
Sharks are tired.
Datsyuk back to Saleh. Back to Datsyuk.
Pavel Datsyuk cuts in, shoots, block, and Heatley can't clear it. Another shot comes wide of the net to Vallin. He'll gain control, try and clear now, but can't get it out. Datsyuk forced wide. Couture, Saturn, and just wide by Holmstrom. Heatley can't get it out. Now it comes out, finally, and the Sharks get a clear.
You need a quick change.
Franzen back in offside.
Holmstrom and Heatley.
They come together, some pushing and shoving, but nothing more for now.
They got to be exhausted, both of them.
Major battle in front between Holmstrom and Vallin. Look at them pushing and shoving, creating space. The two Swedes going at it. Wow. Nick Vallin doesn't get called for penalty there. Absolutely amazing. Again, the battle ensues in front of Antti Niemi. Niemi close to having to make a spectacular save, but deflects off the players in front. The referees just decided, oh, we're just going to let him go there. Sharks just couldn't get the puck out. It was exacerbated by Nick Vallin losing the stick and then the forward giving the stick to Vallin.
A minute 52 left in the third. Tie game thanks to Dan Boyle's goal from Kyle Wellwood and Torrey Mitchell at 15:52. Here's Mitchell with a chance late. He shoots it just wide as he was stumbling on the play. Wellwood back in front, and Mitchell's shot went high.
Now this is the line that's been very good again for the Sharks.
Here come the Red Wings. Do they have an answer late? Wellwood back checking against Filppula, but Filppula comes off the boards with the puck. He'll skate in, trickles off his stick, and Wellwood has to turn back from pressure by Hudler. Swept around. Erickson with time to keep it in. Jonathan Erickson. The shot by Filppula blocked.
Murray.
Now Murray. Thornton's there supporting. So is Mitchell, and he'll just flip this clear through center. A minute left in the third of game three. What a hockey game here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Dan Cleary, nice move around Demers, but good support from Marleau. However, Cleary picks it from him off the boards. Here's Demers coming ahead with it for the Sharks. A pass to Marleau. Patrick Marleau shoots. The save by Howard. Marleau on the rebound. Trying to keep it alive in the corner. Brad Stewart to it for the Wings. Stewart sends it up for Cleary. He's got it in the zone. Dan Cleary shadowed by Vlasic. Less than half a minute to go. A battle on the boards. Vlasic out to Marleau at center. He's alone with Lidstrom back. Throws it at the net. Howard the save. Drops it and decides to cover up with 16 and a half seconds to go.
This has just been nothing but one-on-one battles everywhere in every zone. Guys getting to the pucks first, getting inside position first. It is all about second, third, fourth effort, whatever effort you can bring. And the clear by the San Jose Sharks out of their own zone is a perfect example of that. Also with the Detroit Red Wings cutting off passes behind the net. Outstanding work by all the teams, all the individuals on the ice.
So now a big faceoff late here, a chance for the Sharks with 16 and a half to go. Pavelski in the circle wins the draw back to Ian White. Here's the shot from the line, but in fact it's a pass behind the net. Heatley can't reach it. Draper plays it out to Datsyuk. Datsyuk with a nice play in the neutral zone. Here's Datsyuk, winds up, fakes the shot, saved by Niemi. Heatley clears it to the boards. We're going to overtime again.
That was so close. So close to being ended in the last seconds by the wizardry of Pavel Datsyuk. Antti Niemi comes up big.
We are going to overtime for the second time in this series, and for the San Jose Sharks, their fifth time in these playoffs. Antti Niemi, one of the heroes so far for the Sharks as they battle back to force overtime. 3-3 at the end of regulation. When we come back, we'll check in with the studio. We're going to overtime here at Joe Louis Arena in Detroit. Back
back live in Detroit as we get set for the start of overtime, and we'll have a second overtime through the first three games of this series. Ben Ferriero ended game one, 7:03 into the extra period in his first ever NHL playoff game on his birthday, no less. Made some history for himself right there.
Never a bad play to get the puck on the net in overtime. Get as many shots as you can.
And as we mentioned a moment ago, exactly 1 year ago, on May 4th of 2010, we were in the same spot. Game tied at 3 in overtime. Game 3 of the series. Sharks leading the series 2-0, and Patrick Marleau delivers with the overtime winner. On the pass from Thornton, Sharks took a 3-0 series lead and would wrap up the series in 5 games.
All right, you don't want to see Joe Thornton and Patrick Marleau coming down the ice on a 2-on-1 if you're the other team and it's in overtime, because they will connect.
There are the career playoff overtime goals for the Sharks, Pavelski and Vallin on top of the list with 3 each. Vallin's all coming when he was with the Carolina Hurricanes. And for Detroit, gosh, with all their playoff success, you'd have thought some of those numbers would be bigger. But Franzen leads the way with 2.
Haven't been in overtime that much.
That's right.
Stays winning a regulation.
There's the overtime records of the teams. Todd McClellan, as Sharks head coach, is 8-2 in overtime.
Talking to the players about overtime, and they all say the same thing. They sit there between the period, they look around the room, and they know that one of those guys, one of them is going to score because they've got so much confidence in each other, so much skill in that locker room.
Here we go. 5-on-5, sudden death overtime. A San Jose win. They take a stranglehold lead, a Detroit goal, and they are right back in the series. That's all that's at stake. Dan Boyle, who sent us 2 overtime, up into the neutral zone. Now Marleau carries it through center and gets it deep into Red Wing territory. Brad Stewart back defensively for Detroit. Joe Thornton took the puck off him. Steers it toward the blue line, but out of the reach of Boyle. Both teams with some personnel changes underway. Logan Couture. Cleary tripped up. And a hand pass called in the neutral zone against Detroit.
Obviously, the importance is, as you stated, it's not life or death. It's way more important than that when you're in the playoffs in a situation like this.
Couture's line on, as you saw them. Flo and Heatley flanked by the Sharks' outstanding rookie talent. This is Ruslan Selle for Detroit. Demers checks his shoulder before moving to the puck and gives it neatly to Couture. Back up the boards. Flo took, or Heatley rather, took his eye off the puck. Red Wings skate in. Loose puck to Datsyuk. He waits, centers it, and a block by the Sharks.
What happened was the Red Wings went to the puck first. They got the puck first. Danny Heatley was backing out of the zone. Little play at the blue line keeps the puck in the zone. And then there's just a massive collision at the net. Holmstrom pulls over Vlasic, but look at that block. A couple of guys for the Sharks getting in the shooting lane. Scramble to start things off, but the Sharks survive. You got to make sure you go to pucks. Don't let them get in front of you. Clear the puck out of your zone.
Face-off win by Detroit. Hudler. That comes around to Abdelkader on this side. He's checked by Vallin. Paddle along the boards. Mitchell there, 2 for the Sharks. Hudler for Detroit. And now out to Joe Pavelski. Pavelski, and he comes up to center with it. He's got Wellwood on his right. Pavelski trying to get to the net with it, and he was tripped up. Abdelkader to Erickson. Tries to slide a pass through, blocked by Boyle and cleared down the ice. Pavelski on it as the Sharks change on the fly. 5 in overtime here in Detroit. Devin Setoguchi with 2 San Jose goals tonight. He's on the ice now as Rafalski plays it over to Erickson, up for Dan Cleary. Cleary cross to Bertuzzi. Tries to give back. Instead, the Sharks reverse it.
Marlow across the blue line, puts it on net. Howard the save. Setoguchi to Marlow, back to Setoguchi. He'll give it to Joe Thornton. Thornton will turn back toward the net. Joe Thornton holding off Brad Stewart. Leaves it for Marlow. Setoguchi in front. Marlow was there. Couldn't reach it.
Couldn't get to the step.
And Cleary shoots one that deflects up into the crowd.
Patrick Marlow was trying to step back to the front of the net. Couldn't get off that back post. Some good cycling work by the Sharks down low. Joe Thornton trying to hold off Brad Stewart. Devin Setoguchi's just going to push it out in front. And Patrick Marlow's just on the near side, or far side of the post. Couldn't get to the near side.
Faceoff comes out of the San Jose zone. That's the point from which Cleary took the shot. And it's bunted up to center ice. Back to the line. Red Wings come in. It's Datsu. Took it off his skate to Holmstrom. He skates in. Niemi the save. Puck is loose. And picked up in the corner by Clough. Could fire it out. Couture back for White. A return pass for Heatley off his stick and down for icing.
You want to talk about battling? You want to talk about fighting to keep the puck out? Check out Antti Niemi. Beautiful pickup, and then Thomas Holmstrom tries to block her. One, two, three saves, whacking away at the puck. And Antti Niemi blocking everything. Sharks have to be better on those entries. They got to make sure they organize back into their own zone.
Face off, Red Wings have it. Eaves down behind the net, walks it out. Forehand shot blocked by Couture. Salais at the point. He'll drive it around behind the net, out of the reach of Helm. Heatley comes across, tries to backhand it clear.
Stuck in the pads.
Helm with it. And now Vallin behind the net to White. Helm darted in, has the puck. Darren Helm shoots it behind the net wide. Now Salais, he'll chip for Helm. Has Draper in front. Couture, got a piece of the puck. Helm still got it. Darren Helm out front. A chance for the Red Wings. Patrick Eaves, and he shot it wide.
And he got the stick on him.
Salais, and that's blocked by White. And Clough now will have a chance to clear for the Sharks. Up to center, and Heatley sweeps it deep.
That line's been good. Draper, Helm, Eaves. Been a very good line for the Detroit Red Wings.
Stretch pass up through the middle, goes all the way down. Demers for the Sharks, supported by Vlasic. He'll rim it around, and he gave it away. In front, a chance for Hudler. Broken up by Wellwood. Sharks trying to come out cleanly, and it'll be Demers. Sends it across for Vlasic. Mitchell on the wing, trying to fight off a check. Works it around for Pavelski. Filppula there, he can't clear it from behind the net. Erickson and Pavelski battle. Joe Pavelski comes out with the puck, shoots it wide. Demers keeps it in, but his deep attempt blocked. Here's Vlasic getting across, and it's cleared out to center, and Marlow's got it. He's got Wellwood with him. He'll chip it across, trying to reach Wellwood with the pass. Abdelkader sweeps it back up ice. And Hudler will flip it just wide of the San Jose net.
Was that a play by Mark Edward Vlasic, the race for that loose puck that might have created a two-on-one?
Joe Thornton, nice move through the neutral zone. Thornton shoots, saved by Howard. Rebound, Setoguchi was there, couldn't find it. Dan Cleary back the other way. Passes into traffic, comes back to Lidstrom. He dumps it into the San Jose zone. Boyle takes his time, lobs it up near center, knocked down nicely by Setoguchi. He has Thornton with him. Joe Thornton at the point. Joe Thornton trying to get a shot to the net. As the family's coming, a penalty up. Call, and there will be a San Jose penalty for holding.
Antti Niemi was coming out of the net.
He thought it was going the other way. Devin Setoguchi is going to the penalty box.
Play goes into the zone. And
to me, like Eaves had Setoguchi's arm trapped a little bit.
Is it Eaves or Bertuzzi?
Bertuzzi.
Well, the power plays have been the story of the game. Sharks need a huge kill. The power play has worked very well for Detroit tonight, as it has for San Jose.
5-11, time of the penalty to Devin Setoguchi. So now this Detroit power play that has two goals on four attempts. Check that, two on three attempts. Goes to work here in this overtime. Lidstrom back
in his own zone. Datsyuk for Zetterberg. With control, comes into the zone. Sets up shop on the half boards. Back to Datsyuk. Pavel Datsyuk in front for Zetterberg. They scored a similar goal in game two.
Excellent collapse defensively by Logan Couture.
Lidstrom tees it up and shot it wide. Zetterberg back to the point, but Couture blocked it.
Two good defensive plays by Logan Couture, and starts that penalty kill off.
That one runs all the way back to center. Now Lidstrom carefully into the zone for Holmstrom, and it's forced out by Vlasic. In comes Valtteri Filppula. Looks across the ice. Datsyuk moves to the slot. Here's Lidstrom. On the wing, the shot, a scoop shot, the one up high. That'll come outside the zone.
Logan Couture, a couple of nice plays defensively. Comes back into the zone. And this is one that he's going to knock down as it goes out back out to the point. Quick stick of Logan Couture. You just don't expect that as a player when you're making a pass. You don't expect guys to be able to knock pucks down, but so many players are so good at it now. Great high-hand coordination.
55 left in the minor penalty to Setoguchi, and they're going to redo the faceoff. 1 second came off the clock, and they'll add that back on. Talking to the linesman as Thornton gets a stick down for this faceoff. Sharks win the draw, but it came through to Franzen. He sends it around. Filppula to the blue line. Cronwall shot blocked by Thornton. Bounces right back to Filppula, or Cronwall rather, now to Hudler. He'll turn behind the net. Play it into the corner for Franzen. Two Sharks there, Thornton and Vlasic. And Vlasic cleared.
Quick battle in the corner.
Half a minute left. Sharks have the long change here, but they get it executed in time as Filppula with some speed through the middle. Wants Hudler on the near side. Goes all the way to Franzen, back to Hudler, but he can't catch it. Pavelski angling across, and now Marleau with one man back. It's Cronwall. Patrick Marleau skates in. Marleau skates in, and he can't get the shot away. Now Franzen. Penalty's over. Setoguchi comes onto the ice. Drop pass to Filppula. He'll put on the brakes. Filppula across to Eriksson, and he shot it wide off a block. This one comes to Hudler, and he can't hold the zone. Check it, it's Rafalski. Back to Eriksson and on to Johan Franzen. We're in overtime here in Detroit as the Sharks have killed a penalty early here. Boyle slapping it around, kept it on the boards. In front, a chance for Zetterberg. Niemi the save, and he covers.
Zetterberg all by himself. The Wings do a great job of sealing off the boards. Patrick Marleau, with a few seconds left on the penalty kill, trying to do it one-on-one, and almost does. Almost pulls it off. Good back check by the Detroit Red Wings. And then as Dan Boyle tries to clear it, Wings seal off the board. Sharks get caught with Zetterberg all by himself in front. Antti Niemi, though, not letting anything get near him on that one. He just spread out his legs and said, give me that puck. I'm just going to stop the play.
Draper against Nickel on this faceoff.
Kicking them both out.
Instead, it'll be Wellwood and Helm. See if they both last. And it's Draper now coming off the boards with it for Detroit, but he gives it back to Wellwood. Wallin trying to kick it from his skate to his stick. Goes deep into Detroit territory. Salais has it. Now Scott Nickel for the Sharks. Danny Heatley out of the corner. Goes to the point. Ian White takes a shot off a skate. Nickel trying to get through the crease as Helm busts out with speed. Darren Helm moves in on Wallin. Drops it for Eaves. Saved by Niemi. Back the other way, Heatley. And he'll push it ahead. Into Datsyuk. His shot wide.
He's sneaky.
Cole almost gave it up.
Pauline steers it to the line, but the Red Wings come up with it again, and they've kind of carried the momentum from the power play into the 5-on-5 Detroit.
And that's what you want if your power play doesn't score.
Franzen behind the net. Wanted Holmstrom. Instead, it goes all the way to Stewart. Now the Sharks, as Klo gets it out to Ferriero at center. Ben Ferriero into the Detroit zone. Joined by Couture and Klo. Ryan Klo tried to reach the point, but it's turned over to Datsyuk. Datsyuk with Holmstrom on his left. Puts it on net, saved by Niemi. Loose to Holmstrom, comes back the other side right to Joe Thornton.
All the forwards coming back right to the net.
And now Thornton pushing it around Cronwall. Here's Setoguchi, scores! Devin Setoguchi, a hat trick, and the Sharks win and lead the series 3-0. Unbelievable! History repeats itself. A year to the day, the Sharks come to Detroit, win it in overtime by the identical score, and now have a stranglehold in the series.
Devin Setoguchi, the hero again, and it's really hard to pick up guys on a change. Comes off the bench. Joe Thornton makes an excellent play, chipping the puck past Erickson, controlling the puck, finding Devin Setoguchi off the bench, and a quick release of Devin Setoguchi, and the Sharks take a 3-0 lead in the series, and Devin Setoguchi gets the third goal of the game, and the Sharks are perfect in overtimes in the playoffs.
A Stanley Cup playoff hat trick for Setoguchi, and no goal sweeter than the third. The winner in overtime at 9:21, and Devin Setoguchi comes up huge for the Sharks in a killer game for the Red Wings. The final score in overtime, the Sharks 4, the Red Wings 3. Sharks post-game live starts now.